The following is a production of CUTV Sports.
Everybody, and welcome to CUTV's coverage of high school football game of the week. Tonight we have a Big Nine conference matchup between the Elizabeth Forward Warriors and the Belle Vernon Leopards alongside of Tyler Harris. I am Cody Jeanette, and Tyler, both of these two schools are only separated by a couple miles. They play in each other's backyards all the time, but Elizabeth Forward is coming off of a big win last week.
A big win indeed it was, Cody. 37-7 over Laurel Highlands. So they look to carry that momentum into this matchup this week against the rival of Belle Vernon.
Yeah, and Belle Vernon, unfortunately, had a little bit of a different story to tell against their last opponent, which was Ringgold.
They did. They ended up losing that one 42-21, Cody. So it was a pretty detrimental loss, but nonetheless, this is a rivalry game, so they're going to look to bring some momentum back, get a pretty big win here against Elizabeth Forward.
Yeah, and an interesting note about that rivalry, it has been almost a year ago to the day that these last two teams have played each other. And Tyler, why don't you tell me more about what happened on a year ago today?
Yeah, 364 days ago, Cody. Actually, there was one day separating that, but nonetheless, it was a pretty impressive matchup. Elizabeth Forward ended up getting the win 35-6 over Belle Vernon. So Belle Vernon is looking to come back strong after that loss almost a year ago today. But nonetheless, it's a rivalry game, so both of these teams are going to be competing very hard.
Well, storms are in the weather forecast. Hopefully they pass by us. But one thing's for sure, you will see a thunderstorm on this football field here tonight. Kickoff is next on CUTV.
Watch CUTV online anytime, anywhere. Check out your favorite original programs, coverage of the biggest events on campus, and cheer on your Vulcan sports teams. CUTV, log on, tune in now. Visit cutv.calu.edu/live.
Think you found every hazard out here today? Think again. The spot you missed could be a killer. That spot on your skin could be skin cancer. If you're a man over 50, you're in a group most likely to develop skin cancer, including melanoma, the kind that kills one person every hour. That's why your best shot is to check for a spot. It's easy. Follow through and check your skin. Go to spotskincancer.org to find out how. A message from the American Academy of Dermatology.
Packers. Vikings. Packers. Vikings.
Packers. Vikings. Red state. Blue state. Vegan.
Carnivore.
We come from different places.
Uptown.
Downtown. Optimist.
Center. We come to different conclusions.
Half empty. Half full.
But when we live united, we create real, lasting change in the building blocks of life. The education, income, and health of our communities,
live.
Our families,
united.
Even the person next to us.
Live united.
Real change won't happen without you. So give, advocate, volunteer, live united. Sign up at liveunited.org.
High School Roundup, bringing you the best coverage of high school football in Western Pennsylvania. Tune in for scores, highlights, analysis, and the best plays from the previous week, plus previews and predictions of the week's biggest games, standings from across the region, and news from around the state. High School Roundup. Catch it. Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays on CUTV.
And welcome back to CUTV's coverage of high school football game of the week at Elizabeth Forward, home of the Warriors. Once again, alongside Tyler Harris, I am Cody Jeanette, and where the Elizabeth Forward Warriors will be welcoming the visiting Belle Vernon Leopards here tonight, Tyler, and it'll be quite a matchup of the quarterbacks here tonight, if I understand correctly.
Yeah, quite the matchup it is. You see there, number 9, and that's Jaquan Davidson for Elizabeth Ford. 14 for 32 attempts, 350 yards passing, 4 touchdowns, 2 interceptions. Travis Snyder from Belle Vernon, the Leopards. That is 29 for 60, 489 yards passing, 9 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. And those two, Cody, are top 5 in the AAA and top 30 in all of the Whippeel. So, I mean, two very impressive quarterbacks here tonight.
I agree with you there. That's that's quite a matchup there here tonight, but that's only part of the reason why we cover games like this. You know, these key matchups are perfect for the for the high school football game of the week on CUTV. As you probably saw for a quick second there, our weather forecast. There's some storms in the area, but we're hoping that they miss us. And I have a feeling tonight, Tyler, that we'll be a little lucky.
I hope so, Cody. Only a 15% chance, 5-mile-an-hour wind, 78 degrees here at the stadium. So we like our odds tonight, but we're going to find out as the game continues. As you see right now, Elizabeth Forward is going to kick off for the opening kickoff. Belle Vernon going to receive in the first half, defer to the second half. So we'll get rolling on this game.
Elizabeth Forward wearing their home black uniforms, Belle Vernon wearing their road white uniforms, and we are underway here at Elizabeth Forward. The return is breaking away. The return man is breaking away to the 45, to the 50, across midfield to the 40 and the 30 and the 20. And Tyler, could we have an opening kickoff touchdown? Yes, we do. Belle Vernon strikes first here at Elizabeth Forward, making it 6-0.
Strikes first and strikes early. That's Derek Berkleeren. I mean, that's a hard name to pronounce, but nonetheless, that's not a hard play to analyze, Cody. That was pure amazingness. As you watch the replay, Cody, look how he takes it to the right side. He sees the open gap right there on that beautiful block. Has to get past number nine, that's Jaquan Davidson. And after that, he has 2 to beat, but he uses his speed to his advantage, and he gets to the end zone on the opening kickoff, Cody.
Really flirting with the sideline, but manages to stay in bounds, and now we will see the extra point attempt. Kicking it will be number 9, Elijah Johnson. Or not Elijah Johnson, I'm sorry, Elijah Johnson is holding it. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Belle Vernon strikes first, 7-0 here on High School Football's Game of the Week on CUTV. Stay tuned for more first quarter action.
You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
And welcome back to Elizabeth Forward, where we saw Belle Vernon strike first here early on in the first quarter, returning the opening kickoff for a touchdown, Tyler. It was probably about a 75-yard run back to strike first here in this game.
Definitely impressive, but now Elizabeth Forward looks to return their own kickoff. Let's see if they can strike the way that Belle Vernon did. It'll be interesting to see if they could.
I'm sure Elizabeth Forward is looking to definitely strike right back, because this is not the way that they would have preferred to welcome Belle Vernon into their stadium. Here's the kick. It is a high kick, and it goes retrieved at the 6-yard line or so. Running back, he will be stopped right at the 25-yard line. So that is where Elizabeth Forward will set up shop for their opening drive of the game.
Jalen French on the return on that one. A pretty decent return. Looked like he had some room after he went through that gap up the middle, but just couldn't keep his feet underneath him. Ended up tripping up early, but Elizabeth Forward's going to look to drive here, Cody. They need a way to answer quick, because, I mean, an opening kickoff return is a huge momentum boost. You don't want Belle Vernon to keep that momentum. They're a dangerous team.
It really is, but Elizabeth Forward has plenty of offensive weapons, putting up that 37-7 victory over Laurel Highlands last week. So we'll see them use those to their full potential. We got two receivers to the right, one to the left, and one man back from the shotgun. It is a draw up the middle, and it will be stopped for no gain right at the 25-yard line.
Jaquan Davidson on the keeper on that one. Jaquan Davidson is a senior quarterback, 6'4", 185 pounds, Cody. So he's got a pretty decent size to him. If you take a look at the replay, he lowers his head there, just couldn't get past the defense. I mean, Belle Vernon brought a good defense out there, but they got to do a little bit more than that to get past on a no-gain play.
Davidson once again lining up in the shotgun, draws them offsides. It will be a false start penalty, I believe, against Elizabeth forward. Or it's going to be offsides against Belle Vernon. So Elizabeth forward will advance 5 yards on the miscue by Belle Vernon's defense.
Yeah, they got a little bit tricky out there on the snap count. Belle Vernon expecting the snap to go off on maybe the first or second call, but however, that wasn't the case. Encroachment will kill a defense, so hopefully that won't pertain.
Second and 5. It is another run up the middle, and he stopped for a 2-yard loss at the 28-yard line.
So far, Belle Vernon's defense defending the run very well. Two plays, two runs for Elizabeth forward. This one, a handoff to Wardropper. Stopped immediately, though. He tried to maybe cut his way left to right, but too late to call. There was white jerseys all around him.
It will be third down and about 7 for Elizabeth forward. Even after the penalty, they are faced with a third and moderate amount of yardage. Davidson in the shotgun. He's looking to pass. He's hurried, scrambling to the outside, to the near side, looking for somewhere to dump it to, and he does, and it is almost caught by number 5. That is Brandon Barr for Elizabeth forward.
However, there's a flag on the play, Cody. Looks like the head referee might have saw something on the line. I believe it might have been a chop block, actually, because I saw a Belle Vernon defender actually go down. We'll see what the referee calls, and I'm sure we'll take a look at it after the replay to see what maybe we can see. But we're going to listen in here. They're discussing what's going on, Cody. There's only one flag, so only one referee saw it. But, however, it was the white cap. It was the head ref. We'll see what he says. And that's what it was, Cody. I believe that was a chop block, but it's going to be declined to force the 4th and 7.
It will be 4th down and 7 for Elizabeth forward, and they'll be looking to punt here on their opening drive, forced to a 3-and-out here, Tyler. So Belle Vernon really making a name for themselves early on in this game.
Well, special teams is a big part of every team, Cody. Whenever your special teams can perform well on the opening kickoff, that's impressive and alone. We're going to see more special teams here from Belle Vernon.
Here's the punt. It is a nice punt. It is caught and no fair catch. He will run it back. He's at the 40. He's at the 45. He's at the 50. He's at the 55. There is a flag on the play. He stops at the 40, going to the 35 now, where he's finally brought down at the 32-yard line, but there will be a flag on the play. Chances are it's another chop block, knowing the punt return. On punt returns, the defense is mostly guilty for that.
Cody Menges on the return on that one. We'll see what the referees decide on this one. I'm guessing it's probably going to be on the receiving team, if I had to guess, Cody, but we'll go ahead and take a look as the band starts playing in the background now. We always like that high school atmosphere, rather.
Yes, yeah, certainly a great atmosphere at a great complex here at Elizabeth Forward. Definitely a great football stadium to be covering high school football game of the week. And it looks like there were offsetting penalties there on that call, so.
Going back to the facility, though, Cody, I'll talk about it real quickly. I like seeing the cars lined up along the outside of the fence here. It's pretty cool.
There were offsetting chop blocks on that pass play, so that is what the call is. So the penalties will offset by rule. There will be no yardage affected, and we will see Belle Vernon set up shop in good field position at the Elizabeth Forward 32. The quarterback for the Leopards is Travis Snyder. He's under center. Actually, no, I apologize. The punt will be re-kicked. The special teams had me fooled there. Yeah, and he's returning it once again right at to the 37-yard line, really close to where they were before, Tyler. And it seems like almost everybody was fooled. I'm not sure what the referee was trying to say there.
I'm not sure at all. But nonetheless, even though he never gave me the call, let's take a look at the Big Nine standings, Cody. The big picture that we're at right now, Wes Mifflin and Thomas Jefferson on top of the charts right now. Elizabeth Ford sitting there in the third. Belle Vernon a little bit further down the list, sitting at six right now. So for Belle Vernon, this is a big game to climb your rank up a little bit. But for Elizabeth Ford, if you want to contend in the Big Nine Conference against those two bigger schools in front of you, you have to win this game, and you have to keep your rank up, because with one loss already, that kind of hurts you.
Yeah, definitely. And Wes Mifflin and TJ are both really tough schools to play against. So we see Belle Vernon set up shop, and the quarterback is hurried and sacked back at the 45-yard line for a loss of about 7 yards.
Mike Fine is the quarterback in for that play. He is a freshman, 6'1", 200 pounds. But nonetheless, that's number 15, Mike Fine. He tries to scramble, Cody, but just can't get away from those black jerseys. Elizabeth Ford putting on a big front on defense right now.
Yeah, that was some great defensive penetration there by Elizabeth Ford to really hurry the quarterback up. I believe that you said it was Mike Fine, the freshman. So Belle Vernon will look to do a retake here on 2nd and 18 with 9:06 left to go in the first quarter. The snap is a running play up the middle, and there's a stop at the 41-yard line for a minimal gain, maybe of about 2 yards or so.
Yeah, that's going to set up maybe a 3rd and 16 right now, Cody. Big stop there on defense again. Containing the run very well, both teams are. So maybe eventually here you're going to start seeing teams pass a little bit more often, maybe mix it up on offense. But something's going to happen here for Belle Vernon as they're faced with a 3rd and 14. They're going to have to do something more than a run because it hasn't worked yet in the previous plays.
3rd down in what may seem like 14 miles for these Belle Vernon Leopards. They're faced with a really long initial 3rd down here. Here's the snap, and Fine is looking to pass. The pass is caught at the 32-yard line, but it will not be enough for the 4th down. And Tyler, we're faced with a 4th down here. We'll see what Belle Vernon, what kind of call Belle Vernon makes here.
Yeah, we're going to see, but we'll take a look at the replay. A nice pass over the middle for Fine, the freshman. But I think you're going to see Belle Vernon stay out on offense here, Cody, because you're in decent amount of field position. You can get the 1st down. That's great momentum. So, you know, keep the momentum in your favor. But if you can't, you still have Elizabeth Ford pushed back enough where you can trust your defense to make the big stop again. They went 3 and out the first time.
Here's the snap, and Fine is looking to pass up the middle, and it falls incomplete. So it will be a turnover on downs for Belle Vernon, and Elizabeth Ford will take over at their own 32.
Fine struggled to find any open receivers on that play. He had all the time in the world, all the protection he really needed. Actually, a little bit of rush there from number 72 from Elizabeth Ford, but just couldn't find that open receiver. Good coverage for Elizabeth Ford on that one.
It was definitely in Belle Vernon's defense early on here, as we were saying earlier. He's really looking strong in the beginning of this game, holding Elizabeth Ford on their first drive to a 3 and out. They look for a repeat of that and another retry at that offensive drive. Even though they did return the initial kick for a touchdown to strike early, they still want to get more points. Elizabeth Ford lines up. Shaquan Davidson is under center. We see Bernadowski go in motion, and the play is running play up the far side, and he's stopped at the 30-yard line for a 2-yard loss.
And there will be a fumble recovery on the play, Cody. Belle Vernon, I believe, just comes up with that one. It looks like Wardropper ended up dropping that one on the run, not able to hold on to it. We'll take a look at the replay, maybe see if it was stripped, see if it was dropped. But nonetheless, he looked very disappointed at the end of that play. We'll take a look here, Cody.
And Tyler, that was a very good eye. I didn't even see the ball come out, but you have a very good sense of perception there.
It was actually stripped there by the Belle Vernon player, which looks like number 57. Number 57 in our rosters is Devin Hannon, a sophomore player, 6'4", 235. Great play for Belle Vernon. Great day by Hannon.
Belle Vernon takes over once again. And they go to the outside for a gain of about 3 yards, and then will be stopped at the 28-yard line for 2nd down and 8.
2nd and 8, and they're going to continue this offensive momentum, or at least the momentum that they kept so far, not even on offense so much. But overall in the game, a good defensive stand. They're moving a little bit on offense now, but their special teams getting the first essential 7 points, defining themselves as a team early in this game. We'll see which way the offense heads now that That defense for Elizabeth Ford, though, they have to stay strong if they want to prevent that scoreboard from going any higher.
Belle Vernon lines up. Pine is in the shotgun. He's looking to pass. He throws a long pass that it falls incomplete. It was a little overthrown for his intended receiver.
There's a flag on the play, Cody. We're going to see what the referees have decided. But great job on coverage there. Daquan Davidson did, the quarterback on offense, but also the cornerback on defense. But we'll see what the referees come up with on this play. They're talking it over amongst themselves again. It looks like Belle Vernon's going to be pushing back a little bit, so it might be a holding call or something along those lines. And it looks like it's what it's going to be, Cody. It looks like it's going to be a holding call.
So Belle Vernon will be pushed back 10 yards for the offensive penalty, and it will be second down and about 18 from very long 19 yards to gain. They're at the 40-yard line. They need to get to the 21. Belle Vernon lines up with two receivers to the left, one to the right, and one man back. Fine is in the shotgun, and he's looking to pass. Passes up the middle. The pass is caught for a gain, and it will be third down and long. Belle Vernon once again faced with a third and long, Tyler.
Good rush from Elizabeth Ford on that one. It looks like number seven was the one who was the rusher, Billy Miles. Did a good job getting to the quarterback early, making him throw sooner than he really intended on it. Able to get the pass off, though. Able to get the reception, but just not enough for the first down. Not even close. Not even close to getting back to the line of scrimmage. Belle Vernon has some work to do here on third down.
Third down and 16 with 6:36 left to go in the first quarter. Fine is in the shotgun. He's looking to pass. Passes to the near side. The pass is caught. The receiver is breaking away to the 20, and he gets the first down. Tyler miraculously gets that first down on that third and long. Great yards after completion right there. He got a lot of them and what was needed for the first down.
Derek Verkleeken on the wide receiver screen. Good job by Fine really scanning that field before he decided to make his throw. And good job by the receiver there. Able to turn upfield, find the open field, and get to the first line, first down line at the 20-yard line. Verkleeken, the name there, he's a sophomore wide receiver. So young talent coming through this system.
Belle Vernon is on the front door of the red zone. And there's a flag on the play. It will be a false start call against Belle Vernon. They will be pushed back farther down the driveway of the red zone now.
A little bit further down, it looks like, should be about 10 yards. But out of the red zone they are. It'll be 5 yards, actually. We're going to see what it is. It was only a 5-yard penalty, so I'm not sure exactly what it was.
It's looking like it is a false start penalty against Belle Vernon, but we never saw any clear indication from the referee, so I'm just taking a very educated guess here. From the 25-yard line, Fine is looking to pass, and he is going to hand it off. It had me faked out, and it will be a loss of about 4 yards. So Belle Vernon will be faced with a second down and 19.
And you see here the defense collapsing the zone here. A good job. Wow, number 72 on the tackle on that one for Elizabeth Ford. 72 on the rosters is Adam Smith. A very good job executing on defense, on the defensive line, able to clog up the holes, not allowing the running back to go much of anywhere.
Both defenses here in this game are looking very strong here early on. The one miscue, though, was Elizabeth Forward special teams with the initial kickoff return. 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. We see Fine rolling out to the outside, looking to pass. The pass is caught, and the receiver is at the 10 to the 5. Ball short of the end zone, but does he get the ball across?
I believe it's going to be short, Cody, but we'll take a look at what they say. It should be first and goal, Cody. We'll take a look at the replay. Fine, hanging in as long as possible before he gets hit again. But great catch right off the fingertips, double covered, comes up with it, uses his height to his advantage, Cody. And I think that knee was down before that ball crossed the plane. That's what the referees have decided as well. It'll be first and goal from the one.
There's only one receiver to the left. They go with the draw up the middle. It is a touchdown for Belle Vernon. Belle Vernon strikes again, making the score 13-0, pending the extra point here against Elizabeth Forward with 4 minutes and 35 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
Leopards doing a great job on offense on this drive, able to execute the pass well from a freshman, and the freshman keeping it himself on that one, just getting the one needed yard to get into the end zone, Cody. So far, the freshman's looking good. Fine is looking fine, and that's exactly what we like to do here on CUTV, use those little slogans. But nonetheless, Belle Vernon liking to use their own offensive and defensive weapons to take an early lead in this one.
We see Belle Vernon lining up for the extra point, kicking it. It is up, and the kick is no good. The score remains 13-0 here on CUTV's High School Football Game of the Week. Belle Vernon leads Elizabeth Forward. Stay tuned for the conclusion of the first quarter.
CUTV is your home for local high school football action. Sundays at 8:30, Thursdays at 5:30, only on CUTV.
You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
And welcome back to Elizabeth Forward Stadium here in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania, where we see Belle Vernon take an early lead of 13-0.
We're going to go ahead and take a look at the almost touchdown that it was after the kick. But let's see what happens on the kickoff first, Cody, because you never know when Elizabeth Forward might strike back on special teams of their own. It's very possible. They got some good weapons back there.
Here is the kick. It is a line drive kick, very long, and it goes into the end zone where it will result as a touchback. So Elizabeth Forward will set up shop from the 20-yard line here with 4 minutes and 35 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
And here's Fine doing what he does best so far in this game. Almost a sidearm throw, almost Brett Favre-like, to the receiver on that one, number 11, Jake Schweitzer. He's a senior, and he's showing it why there. He's also using his height to his advantage. So good job by Schweitzer, able to overcome the double team that Elizabeth Forward was showing him. Use his height to his advantage, catch it with his fingertips, take it down to the one-yard line.
Elizabeth Forward will be setting up shop from the 20-yard line, looking to strike back against Elizabeth Forward's two very early touchdowns here in this game. Jaquan Davidson lines up in the shotgun. The ball is snapped. He's looking to pass. The pass goes up the middle to Bernadowski, where it's in and out of his hands and falls incomplete.
Bernadowski open on that play, just not able to hold on to it. It was a rocket from the quarterback there, just not able to secure it. Bernadowski at least wasn't able to. Yeah, that was a cannon. But just to give you an idea of what happened on that last drive for Mike Fine, 4 for 6, 58 yards, and obviously one rushing touchdown for his own stat sheet. So, I mean, freshman getting some early points in this one.
Davidson once again in the shotgun, but they will draw it up the middle, and it results in a 5-yard gain where they are stopped at the 25-yard line, so it will be about a third down and 5.
Third and 5, and this is actually the best third down situation they've been in all game, Cody. The running back able to carry it up, get a decent yard gain out of it. That's number 25, Ryan Wardropper. That's an interesting last name, Cody, Wardropper. I would like to have that last name.
Well, nonetheless, he's able to provide for his team, getting those yards for what may seem like a short third down now. There is a flag on the play. It's looking like it will be encroachment against Belle Vernon. We'll see what the referee says, and it is. It will be encroachment against Belle Vernon, so they will advance 5 yards, and I believe they will move the chains here because it was 3rd and 5.
1st and 10 for the Warriors, and they'll take that any day of the week. 3:55 left in this one, so they have a little bit of time left in the first quarter to work with the clock and to maybe even put some points up on the board. They're going to need to put some up soon because you don't want to let Belle Vernon pull away from this one.
Jaquan Davidson once again lining up in the shotgun. The ball is snapped. The pass is thrown up the far side, and Bernadowski catches it for a first down gain at the 41. It looks like that's where Forward Progress will put him.
Bernadowski using those dance moves to his advantage, and you'll see why right here. A beautiful pass from Jaquan Davidson, and he breaks the initial first tackle, tries to stutter step backwards, tries to get away from that defender, just not able to do it. They'll wear those neon green socks, so Cody, you and I will be able to see where he's at on the field at all times. Interesting clothing choice there for Bernadowski.
Very much so, and it could prove to be a very distracting factor for this defense. You never know. Davidson lines up in the shotgun. He rolls out to the near side. He looks like he's going to keep it for himself. He takes it to the 54-yard line, or 44-yard line, excuse me.
There's going to be a flag on the play, Cody. That's a late hit from Belle Vernon on Bernadowski. You'll see on the replay maybe, but we'll see what the referee calls. That has to be what the call was, Cody. That was definitely a late hit, a little unnecessary, maybe showing some frustration. But Bernadowski, before that happened, laid a really nice block out to let the quarterback, Davidson, get a couple extra yards.
It is a personal foul against Belle Vernon, Tyler.
Yeah, you'll take a look at the replay, and Jaquan Davidson decided to keep it the entire time. He knew where he was going with it, so he pointed it out, showed where he was going, and here's the block, but you won't see it on the replay, the late hit, unfortunately, but it was there nonetheless. Elizabeth Ford will take those penalties all day, Cody. To get an extra 15 yards down, you know, down the field, put yourself in better field position. They're driving well on Belle Vernon right now, so if I'm Belle Vernon, I'm going to buckle down because this drive's getting out of hand.
Davidson lines up from the 30-yard line. He gives it up the middle, and he's to the 20, to the 17-yard line for a first down gain, and it will be first and 10 from the 17-yard line for Elizabeth Forward, striking into Belle Vernon's red zone for the first time in this game.
That they are. Jalen French, the senior running back, 5'8", 155, a small guy, but nonetheless, he's a speedy guy. That's why he's back there on punt and kickoff returns. But nonetheless, able to show his moves, going right up the middle, wide open hole for him to run through, and he took advantage of it.
We are in the final 3 minutes of the first quarter here in Elizabeth Forward. The pitch goes to the outside, and it will be a gain of about 3 more yards, or 5 more yards or so, for a second down and 5 from the 11-yard line.
Jalen French on the toss on that one. He gets a nice lead block there from the fullback. That's Matthew Hermesman, the sophomore, the junior product, 6 foot, 215 pounds is what he's staturing. He's a pretty big guy. You like to see a fullback that size, especially when they run that pro I formation that they've been running all day, Cody.
Elizabeth Forward's crowd now getting into it. Jaquan Davidson keeps it for himself again, busts out to the far side where he gains enough for a first down inside the 5-yard line, it looks like now, Tyler, and Elizabeth Forward really threatening here at the end of the first quarter.
They ran the option offense on that one, but Davidson decided to keep it himself. He actually had French open on the left side. He might have been able to pitch it to him and get the touchdown, but nonetheless, Davidson felt he might be able to do it himself. Still puts yourself in great field position. First and goal for the first time all game for the Warriors. They're looking to take advantage of it. 2:04 left in this one.
First and goal from the 4, and Davidson looks like he will be in the shotgun with 2 receivers to the left and 1 to the far right. Bernadowski goes in motion. The ball is fumbled. Ball is fumbled by Bernadowski, and it looks like Belle Vernon is on the recovery, and they are. It is Belle Vernon's football from the 14-yard line. Tyler, and another offensive miscue for Elizabeth Forward proves to be costly.
Very costly. They just had the best drive of their game so far, but Bernadowski struggling a little bit right now. Had one good catch earlier in the drive, but he also dropped one. He fumbles one. He had such a big game last week for Elizabeth Forward against Laurel Highlands, and you expected him to carry that with him into this one, but just struggling early right now. If you're Elizabeth Forward, you're looking to him to maybe try to work on that, but Elizabeth Forward's going to take a timeout, and we're going to take a look at the Big Nine schedule for tonight. And as you take a look at the long shot there of Warrior Stadium, a beautiful facility here, Cody. We like to call it the zombie shelter, but we'll take a look at the Big Nine matchups tonight. Albert Gallatin versus at West Mifflin, Hampton at Laurel Highlands, Uniontown at Ringgold, Trinity at Thomas Jefferson. So a couple good games here and there throughout the Big Nine Conference. Thomas Jefferson and West Mifflin leading the charge right now in the Big Nine. So if you're these two teams playing right now that we're on, West Elizabeth Forward and Belle Vernon, you want to see one of those two teams maybe fall because you want to take that spot that's going to open up.
Yeah, there's Tyler. We're looking at the fumble here again by Bernadowski, and that's a that really proves to be costly. Bernadowski's looking up in frustration. You can really tell he's frustrated. But Belle Vernon on the recovery there. And that's the second turnover, I believe, for Elizabeth Forward here just in the first quarter alone.
Yeah, Bernadowski took his eyes off the ball, Cody, and you can't do that when you're taking a handoff. You got to make sure you have control of it before you take off up the field.
Here we see Belle Vernon set up shop from the 11-yard line. The ball goes to the outside where it will be stopped at the 18-yard line for a gain of about 5, and it will be second and 5 from the 19-yard line.
Derek McLaren, again on the carry, proved very well in the first play of the game whenever he took it up the right sideline to get that first kickoff return touchdown. But now he's the running back for Belle Vernon, getting some yardage for himself.
100 seconds are left in this first quarter. See the snap. And the ball is stopped for no gain right at the 16-yard line. A little bit of extracurricular activity maybe. We saw the whistles blow for a little length of time, but nothing called. So we will resume.
We will resume. A minute left now as the time's starting to click down on the scoreboard for the first quarter. It's going to be third down and about 4 yards, Cody. If you're Belle Vernon, you definitely want to get this first down. You still got a whole quarter to play before you go to halftime, so you want to make sure. I mean, a long drive here would be substantial for the Leopards.
Not to mention that Belle Vernon will be kicking to Elizabeth Forward to start the second half. So, yeah, you're right, Tyler. It's two-minute drill time for these Leopards. Here's the snap. Fine is looking to pass. The pass is long up the right side. There is a flag on the play as the pass gets overthrown. The flag is thrown at around the 40-yard line, so it happened way in the backfield, or in the secondary, excuse me. I got my perspectives backwards.
I believe this one's actually going to be on Belle Vernon, Cody. I'm not exactly sure. The flag was thrown actually from the line of scrimmage, just threw it forward to the 40. That was a long throw on that one. But we'll see what the head referee comes up with here. It's actually going to be on Elizabeth Forward. Defensive holding on Bernadowski, I believe, who was on the coverage on that play. We'll see if we can see it on the replay. But nonetheless, here's the pass. Yeah, there was definitely some grabbing before the camera got to where the play actually happened and ended. But Bernadowski was the faulty on that one, trying to grab the jersey, hold him back from making the play.
26.7 seconds left. Belle Vernon snaps it and sends it up the middle where it will be stopped for a minimal gain of about 2 yards or so at the 30-yard line.
And that play should end the first quarter, Cody, as time's clicking down here, about 13 seconds left. Impressive showing so far from Belle Vernon, Cody. Up 13-0 against Elizabeth Forward. Good special team showing, good defensive showing as well. Able to take over the forced turnovers for Elizabeth Forward.
After one quarter of play, your score reads Belle Vernon 13, Elizabeth Forward 0. Stay tuned for the second quarter of High School Football Game of the Week on CUTV.
Need to know what's happening in your area? CUTV News Center brings you your best local news. Events on and around campus. Local weather. Vulcan sports coverage. CUTV News Center, live Thursdays at 5.
You are watching CUTV, California University Television.
And welcome back to CUTV's coverage of High School Football Game of the Week. Both teams have taken the hike down to the other end of the field, as they always do after the end of each quarter. The second quarter is about to start here from Warrior Stadium in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania, where we will see Belle Vernon set up shot from the 29-yard line. Fine pitches it to his running back. There is a flag on the play. There are two flags on the play, unless they are for the same penalty, as the running back is stopped at the 35-yard line.
I believe both refs might have saw the same thing, and I think that might be offensive holding on Belle Vernon, and penalties have really killed Belle Vernon so far. Five penalties for 40 yards, and Elizabeth Forward, one penalty for 10 yards. So penalties really hurting Belle Vernon early in this one, and if this one is in fact a penalty for Belle Vernon, it's going to hurt him more, and that's what it is. That's another 10 yards. That's six penalties for 50 yards now, Cody.
Just half of the field covered in penalties alone for Belle Vernon here tonight. 11:53 left to go in the second quarter. Second quarter is just underway here. Belle Vernon really striking early on from the first kickoff onward, and they've really been standing strong ever since.
Second now, and 19 for Belle Vernon.
As you probably just heard the PA announcer here at Warrior Stadium, it is second and 19 for Belle Vernon. Here's the snap. Fine is dropping back, looking to pass, but he gets way hurried back and evades a few tackles, still on his feet. It takes three Elizabeth Forward defenders to bring him down, and he's sacked all the way back at the 4-yard line, Tyler.
Matthew Hermesman on the initial hit on that one as you take a look at the replay. Good job by Fine standing up to those hits. Look at that hit right there, Cody. Absolutely crushing. Still able to get off the defenders, trying to stiff arm, trying to do whatever he can to keep the play alive, but it ended up hurting him in the long run because it pushed him back five additional yards. And now they're going to set up shop right around the 2-yard line, Cody. That's something that you don't want to do.
It will be third down and 19 from the 3-yard line. The third and 32, I apologize. The scoreboard was a little delayed with the updates, but it will be third down and 32 for Belle Vernon. 32 miles, it may seem like. Looking to pass is fine. The pass is up the middle and is incomplete. Belle Vernon will be forced to punt from deep in their own end zone.
Elizabeth Forward running the zone defense right now, Cody, and doing a good job of it, as Bernardowski is the one who comes through and breaks up that play with the helping hand of number five, Brandon Barr, on defense. So a lot of good defensive weapons in that backfield for Elizabeth Forward, and they're also the same weapons on offense. But now Belle Vernon's pinned back deep in their own territory. This would be a bad time for a mistake if you're the long snapper or the punter in this situation.
Belle Vernon looking to punt, and there it goes. It is a high and short punt, only going out to the 30-yard line, excuse me. Bernardowski will retrieve it at the 45, and he will return it. Nimbling back and forth, back and forth. He breaks away from the defenders. He's at the 20, he's at the 15, he's at the 10, he's at the 5. It is a touchdown for Elizabeth Forward. Bernardowski on the punt return for the second week straight, Tyler. He has returned a punt for a touchdown. Truly unbelievable there.
My mind is blown, Cody. This kid is so talented. I can't stress it enough. He lets the punt bounce, which he should have, but the punt takes a good bounce towards the 50-yard line. Bernardowski dances. He's a dancer. He must go to ballet classes, honestly, Cody, because he scrambles away from that sea of white jerseys, gets a great block here from the receiver. He jukes out the last player and gets to the end zone. I don't know how he did it, Cody. I really don't.
It really is unbelievable, but like you said, he's a very talented player. And I thought he was going down right as soon as he caught it at the 45-yard line. It seemed like he was going back and forth, going to that yard line, but he manages to break away and get the touchdown. Kicking the extra point for Elizabeth Forward will be Adam Stitt. Here is the kick. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Elizabeth Forward strikes back with 10:08 left to go in the second quarter. Your score, Belle Vernon 13, Elizabeth Forward 7. Stay tuned for more coverage of High School Football Game of the Week on CUTV.
High School Roundup, bringing you the best coverage of high school football in Western Pennsylvania. Tune in for scores, highlights, analysis, and the best plays from the previous week, plus previews and predictions of the week's biggest games, standings from across the region, and news from around the state. High School Roundup. Catch it. Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays on CUTV. You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
Welcome back to Warrior Stadium here in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania, where we just saw Elizabeth Forward strike with an offensive touchdown to make it 13-7, cutting into Belle Vernon's early lead with 10:08 left to go in this second quarter.
I wouldn't even call it offensive, Cody. That was a special teams act there. So both teams showing, flexing their special teams muscles so far in this game as the punt's away.
The kick is a squib. It is retrieved at the 15-yard line, where it will be returned to the 25, breaking to the outside to the 30. And he stopped at the 34-yard line, and that is where Belle Vernon will set up.
Derek Verkleeren on the return on that one. A very hard name to pronounce, Cody. But nonetheless, a great job here by Elizabeth Forward. And here's Bernadowski doing what he does best, and that's return kickoffs. And he's showing why right here. I mean, absolutely amazing. A great block there from some of his teammates. Great blocking all in all. Didn't look like a good idea at first, but he proved me wrong later.
Definitely a nominee, if I may say so, Tyler, for High School Roundup's Play of the Week. And he already has the best of the best, if I'm not seriously mistaken, on that segment.
Yeah, he's going to try to one-up himself now.
Here's the snap. It is a run up the middle, and there are flags everywhere as the ball is stopped at the 38-yard line.
I believe that's going to be a face mask, Cody, on Zach Spade, the runner on that one, the fullback. But I'm sure the refs are going to conclude the same thing that I just said, Cody, but we'll find out. Elizabeth Ford is walking backwards. I think they know what they did, too.
The referees are in the midst of their discussion after the penalties, making sure everything is correct. And Belle Vernon taking their march forward, as it will be, as you said, Tyler, a personal foul call against Elizabeth Forward.
Personal foul, face mask call against Forward, a 15-yard penalty.
And he will take the ball up the middle, and there it is right there. Warhammer, I believe, was the guilty person on that one, number 25, so something you never want to see. I mean, when you try to make the tackle like that, you never know what you're grabbing for. You're just grabbing to grab.
And sometimes you get a handful of mask, and that's very unfortunate for the defender, but it happens sometimes. Belle Vernon sets up from the 46-yard line, and the ball is stopped for no gain right at the same yard line, so it will be second down and 10 for the Leopards.
Take a look at the replay here. Fine handing off to his running back, but that sea of black and red just coming down on top of the running back there. Just not able to get anywhere. 21 on the carry. Bradley Sloan, so he's a junior. Still got one more year left after this one. Maybe he'll get a little bit of experience this year and next year to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Mike Fine goes under center with two receivers to his right and one to his left and one man back. Here's the snap. He is looking to pass. The pass goes up the middle, and it is caught for a gain of about 6 yards to the 41-yard line, where it will be third down and about 5 from that yard line with 8:42 left to go in the second.
Great time staying in the pocket here as they had a person come through and try to rush the play. But good job by the receiver again, number 11. That's Jake Schweitzer, able to hold on to that. He's a senior. He's the one that made that beautiful catch earlier in the game to get him on the 1 yard line.
Mike Fine, excuse me, all under center. The pass goes to the near side and is caught, but Bernadowski on a big hit after the catch. It will be a minimal gain, if anything. And
Derek Verkleeren on the reception there, but man, what a hit. What a hit by number 81 for Elizabeth Ford. Again, that's Bernadowski. Having a good game so far, except for that one fumble, but able to recover well. He's showing his worth, honestly, on the punt return, on that tackle there. Very good player to have on your team.
It will be fourth down for the Leopards, and we will see the punt team come on. from the 46-yard line. The punt will go underway. Bernadowski is back to retrieve it, but there is a flag on the play before the snap.
It'll be a delay of game penalty on Belle Vernon, Cody. They wanted to maybe have five extra yards to work with on the punt. So they're going to take that wattage. But it might actually help out Bernadowski in the long run, since he did just return one. If the upfront special teams for Elizabeth Ford could do some good blocking, he might be able to do the same thing again.
Fourth down and 9 for Belle Vernon. The snap is high, but it is caught, and here's the punt. It is another short punt, only going to the 41-yard line, where it will be bounced out of bounds for Elizabeth Forward.
We'll take a look at Elizabeth Forward's schedule coming up here. As you see, we're currently playing Belle Vernon, but they have to go to Uniontown next, and then you got a tough two games coming up after that. One at home against West Mifflin, then you have to travel to Ringgold and play a tough game there. Good student section at Ringgold, so that's always a hard atmosphere to play in. Then you end the season with Albert Gallatin and Greensburg-Salem. So Elizabeth Forward, these are definitely two games that you definitely want to prepare yourself on, especially this one, Cody. This is a tough matchup for Elizabeth Forward so far, and they want to definitely work on what they have to work on before you come up against those two tougher teams.
Jaquan Davidson will be in the shotgun for Elizabeth Forward, with three receivers to his right and two to his left, but there will be a stoppage in play with a little bit of an issue with the clock, but it looks like we'll be resuming. So here's the snap, and Davidson is looking to pass, but he is hurried. Scrambles to the far side, and there's a flag on the play, but a long pass that is caught at the 10-yard line. Belle Vernon's defender's helmet flies off, but there's flags all over the backfield. So we'll have to see what happens. It looks like this play is coming back.
This play is definitely going to come back, Cody. There's offensive holding everywhere on this one. Flags were thrown early and for good reasoning. Big play for Elizabeth Forward, but just not, it's not legal due to the yellow flags thrown through the air.
Yeah, there were a lot of them flying through, and a lot of referees saw it, so Elizabeth Forward will be pushed back to the 30-yard line, it looks like. That looks like that's where they'll be meeting up. There's 7 minutes and 16 seconds left to go in this first half. Belle Vernon leading 13-7.
We'll take a look at the replay here. You might have saw it on the right of your screen. But wow, what a great catch. Able to beat out the defenders there. The receiver was number one. That's Anthony Brown. But unfortunately, it's not going to stand. It's going to be a first and 30, Cody. If you're Elizabeth Ford, you got some work to do here.
First down and 30 from the 20-yard line. Davidson in the shotgun looking to pass. He is hurried once again, scrambling to the near side, looking for someone to throw to, and he does throw, and the pass will be intercepted by Belle Vernon at the 47-yard line, and Belle Vernon will take over with 6:59 left to go in the half.
Aaron Indoff on the interception there. That's the third turnover now for Elizabeth Ford, rather. Good job by Jaquan Davidson trying to keep the play alive, but whenever you throw a pass like that, that's a hope and a prayer for most quarterbacks. Wardropper just not able to have any say in what happened there. Unfortunately for Elizabeth Ford, that's another tough break. So they're going to have to try to defend this Belle Vernon team again.
That is the third turnover for Elizabeth Ford, as you said, Tyler. They're proving to be really costly here early on, as Belle Vernon has the lead of 13-7. Fine is going to hand off, and the run will go up the far side to right around midfield for a gain of about 4.
4-yard gain there for Belle Vernon. You'll take as much yards as you can get. Those little chip plays often end up working in the long run. Again, Sloan on the carry on that one, Bradley Sloan. So able to get a couple yards. If you can just chip away at this Elizabeth Ford defense, really wear them out, that'll help wear out the offense as well. And overall, that'll help you be more successful in the long run.
Second down and 7 from the 49-yard line. We'll have to wait as there is an official's timeout. Here it may might be another clock issue. I'm not sure, Tyler, what's going on here.
Yeah, another clock issue. They're going to add a couple seconds on to the scoreboard and let them resume play now.
Here's the snap. Fine hands it off. Once again, the run is taken up the middle, and he'll be stopped just short of the first down. First down marker being at the 44-yard line. Looks like his team went down at the 45. It will be third down and one with 6:06 left to go in the half.
Yeah, Sloan doing a good job trying to find what he can in those holes that the offensive line is making, weaving his way through those black jerseys of Elizabeth forward and chipping away slowly but surely at that Warrior defense.
Belle Vernon will line up with two receivers to the right and two men back. Fine is under center. He hands it off. The run goes up the gut for a gain of about 4 yards. It will be enough for a first down for the Leopards.
Over the pile he went, and he will be Derek for Gleeren. Again, hops over the pile. Just he knows where he has to be, and he gets there, able to get that first down, just chipping away slowly, using that clock to their advantage now for the rest of this half.
They will move the chains. The first down marker will be at the 32-yard line for Belle Vernon. 5 minutes, 22 seconds left to go in the half. Your score, Belle Vernon 13, Elizabeth Forward 7. Fine hands it off. Once again, the running back goes to the outside. He's at the 30 where he's brought down for another first down for Belle Vernon.
For Clear and going up to the left side. Doing a great job overall, finding his open routes as he cuts to the left there. Gets past Wardropper, and Bernardowski able to bring him down, trying to strip it, but good job there by the running back. They're able to hold on to it.
The officials will start the clock as the gameplay clock resumes, and it will be first and 10 for the Leopards. Knocking on the door once again in Elizabeth Forward's end. Fine is under center. A little bit of play action. The pass goes to the near side, and it is caught at the 25-yard line for a gain of 5 yards.
Laquan Dixon on that reception there. Again, they're just doing little things, eating up that clock, not letting Elizabeth Forward, if they score, at least Belle Vernon, if they score, they're not going to let Elizabeth Forward have enough time to do anything on offense to retaliate, because Belle Vernon gets the ball back. Elizabeth Forward gets the ball back upon the second half, so you don't want to let them score and get any points before the half's over.
Yeah, this is a true test for Elizabeth Forward's defense here as the minutes continue to wind down here in the first half. The run goes up the middle, and he is stopped at the 20-yard line, where it will be enough for a first down for Belle Vernon once again with 4 minutes left to go in the first half.
Good job by Brooke Lear in here, finding his hole up the middle, able to beat the first tackler, just grinding his way forward, keeping his feet moving until they can't move anymore, just chipping away at this Elizabeth Forward defense and being successful so far with it, putting on a nice long running drive. Only one pass play so far in it.
They've been able to eat up the clock and gain some yardage while they're at it. And we see another run play once again go to the near side, and it is a gain of about four more yards for Belle Vernon. And that will be the first down. I apologize, the last play was not enough, but this one is.
Bernardowski on the tackle on that one. But again, it's just pretty much repetitive motion now. You would think Elizabeth Forward might be able to catch on to what's going on, but struggling to do so. Belle Vernon, the Leopards, doing a great job on offense on this drive, eating away the clock. I believe about 4 minutes has elapsed since their drive started.
Certainly a big portion of the clock, regardless, has been melted off of the scoreboard since Belle Vernon took over control after the turnover. There are flags on the play as the running back is stopped for a loss at the 20-yard line.
I believe you're going to see a holding call on Belle Vernon. They're walking backwards now. I think they know what they did, but the referees are going to talk about what happened on that one. But I'm sure that's what it's going to be, Cody. That's going to hurt Belle Vernon again. Very penalty-rich in this one they are.
Yeah, definitely. But Elizabeth Forward is looking for any kind of break that they may be able to get right now, and this might be it. As they are pushed back 10 more yards, and it will be second or first and 20, I beg your pardon.
Holding call against Belle Vernon, 10-yard penalty for the spotted infraction.
If Elizabeth Forward can't improve on defense, Cody, this only helps out Belle Vernon in the long run if they continue to execute on offense the way they have, because you're getting closer and closer with 2:59 left. Clock is about to become an issue. It's going to be interesting to see what happens now, how they change their offensive play.
One receiver to each side, two men back. Play action. Fine passes up the middle, and it falls incomplete, which will stop the clock at 2:45.
Davidson on the tight man coverage on that one, not even allowing Fine to put it in the range of the receiver. He saw Davidson all over the receiver, and he knew to make the better decision of not throwing the ball, because it might have been an interception. And that's the last thing you want to see if you're Belle Vernon.
Yeah, that really is. After being called for so many penalties here in this first half, it's a moderate surprise that they have the lead still, but that initial kickoff return for the touchdown is proving to be really, really key here for this Leopard offense. And that's what has them the lead. If it weren't for that, the score could possibly be tied right now.
We're going to go ahead and take a look at Belle Vernon's schedule to this point. And there's a timeout on the field. So Belle Vernon called the timeout, but nonetheless, you got Franklin Regional coming up if you're Belle Vernon. That's going to be a tough matchup. Then afterwards, you got Trinity. Then you go to Thomas Jefferson. That's always a tough matchup. Then you have Laurel Highlands and Albert Gallatin to end out the year. So this, they really got the big part of their schedule out of the way early. But TJ, looming there, that's your third to last game of the year. And again, you have to travel to Thomas Jefferson. That's always tough.
Yeah, TJ is really just looming there at the bottom of the schedule, as you said. It's going to prove to be a very key game if Belle Vernon is going to be making a playoff run.
Belle Vernon is still going over what they want to do here on offense. 2:45 left in the first half, so almost entering two-minute drill phase. Belle Vernon is. They might probably just go ahead and perform the two-minute drill now. See what they can do as they come out in the I formation.
It will be second down and 23, it seems like, from the 30-yard line. Belle Vernon faced with a long second down here. And Fine is looking to pass as a screen pass to his running back. The running back breaks up the far side to the 19-yard line, where he stumbles to the 16, and that is where it will be.
Back to the original line of scrimmage. Great screen pass there to the running back to the left side, Bradley Sloan. Oh, actually, no, again, that is number 20, Derek Verclearen, actually, on the reception. I thought it might have been Bradley Sloan. He's been playing a lot of halfback as well. But Verclearen doing a good job so far this game on offense for the Leopards, proving himself pretty well.
We are approaching the two-minute mark here in this first half. There's 2:06 left. Belle Vernon threatening to score once again here against Elizabeth Forward, looking to go into the halftime with a positive note, but that is certainly not a positive note, as it will be a false start penalty against Belle Vernon. They will back up 5 yards.
That's about their eighth or ninth penalty all so far this game, Cody. If it wasn't for those penalties and for that yardage that made up those penalties, they'd probably have at least another touchdown on their hands, really hurting themselves, really shooting themselves in the foot. They really got to crank down on that in the second half, become a little bit more focused, because they could be doing a lot better against this Elizabeth Forward team if it wasn't for those penalties.
Yeah, every team going into that locker room at halftime has those little things that get addressed, and for Belle Vernon, it seems like it will certainly be the penalties and the penalty yards. Here's the snap. Fine is going to stop with the ball as there is another flag on the call. It will be encroachment against Elizabeth Forward, so they'll march right back to where they were before. It will be 3rd and 10.
Yeah, Elizabeth Forward now starting to shoot themselves in the foot themselves. I believe that's their third or fourth penalty on the evening for them. So you're giving Belle Vernon more optimal play positioning now. 16-yard line, 1:56 left. Got some time and some yardage to work with.
Three receivers are to the right and one is to the left. Fine hands it off to his lone back, where he will be stopped for no gain at the 16-yard line, where it will be 4th down with 1:36 left to go in the first half. We'll see what Belle Vernon does here, if they want to go for a field goal or if they want to go for it.
Yeah, I think they're going to go for the field goal, Cody. I'm surprised to see on that one that they didn't try to run it more towards the center of the field, give the kicker a little bit of an easier time. But they're going to go ahead and kick the field goal, try to put up three more points on the board. Minute 13 left and counting.
This will be about a 30-yard attempt or so, 31 yards, with 1 minute left to go in the first half.
It looks like, Cody, that they're going to take the delay of game, 5 seconds and counting on the play clock, and that's what they're going to do. As we see the flag finally called there. Oh, timeout for Belle Vernon, actually. But, Cody, one of my personal favorite things to do here at CUTV is our show called High School Roundup. It is a great show, honestly, and if you guys are a fan of high school football from around the area, Cody, I suggest you watch it because you and me and ATL Zach Lamar are always on that show giving you the analysis of high school action around the area, highlights, scoreboard, standings, plays of the week, and more on High School Roundup. We have a blast, and you will have a blast if you watch it, of course.
It is fun. It's a fun time filming it and watching it as well. And you see the plays of the week and the best of the best, where number 81 for Elizabeth forward Bernadowski will be featured. He will be contending against whatever top play it may be that happens this week. The story still has yet to be written for a lot of these games here around the area. And as Belle Vernon lines up, it'll be a 32-yard field goal attempt for the Leopards with 48 seconds left to go in the half. Here's the snap. The kick is up. It is far enough, but is it lined up enough? It is no good. Wide left for Belle Vernon. A missed field goal attempt. The score remains 13-7 in favor of the Leopards.
43 seconds left in the half, Cody. If you're a Elizabeth forward, you gotta maybe put some points on the board if you can. But another thing that you should check out from CUTV, of course, is CUTV Online. Live programming stream is at cutv.calu.edu. And you can also check us out on YouTube. CUTV Sports 1 is our headline on that one. But, I mean, you can check out any footage that we have from our high school game of the week, college game of the week, news center, any videos, any TV shows we do. You can check out the whole shebang online, Cody.
And you can also watch full soccer games and CalU football games in their entirety, which is a beautiful thing as well. The pitch goes to Bernadowski. He breaks to the near side at the 30, will be taken down just near the out of bounds line at the 32-yard line for Elizabeth forward, and it stops the clock at 36 seconds.
Yeah, good job by Bernadowski being aware of that. You know, he has to take advantage of that sideline because that's going to be your best friend in the next 36 seconds. I believe he needs to run a little bit faster on that one, though, because he might have, on that stutter, taken up an extra second that really needed to be. But nonetheless, Elizabeth forward getting the first down on that play.
Every nanosecond is counting here for Elizabeth forward, it may seem like. Davidson keeps it for himself and gets taken down at the line of scrimmage. Clock continues to run at 27 seconds, and there is a timeout called by Elizabeth forward, stopping the clock at 27 seconds.
I'm interested to see why they decided to keep it up the middle rather than take it out to the outside by Jaquan Davidson, maybe even pull a play-action fake, use his speed to their advantage. And they also called a timeout just a little bit later on that one, Cody. I'm questioning as to why that is. Nonetheless, we're not the ones, making the calls out on the sidelines. We're just the ones up here in the booth making the call, so maybe they know something that we don't.
We call the action as it happens from what we can see, and the officials know what they see, and we hope to know what they see here all the way up in the press box area of Warrior Stadium, where we get the grand view of everything, Tyler. It's a beautiful view from up here. The lights come on. It's Friday Night Lights atmosphere.
The fog settles in the background where the cornfield is across the yonder, Cody. The cheerleaders on the sidelines doing flips, cheering their teams on. The fans in the stands from Elizabeth forward and from Belle Vernon, these two schools are very close to each other. And also, you see the Elizabeth forward offense and the Belle Vernon defense as well. Great atmosphere, Cody.
And also, you're going to be seeing the marching bands here at halftime. So lots of elements in this atmosphere. Davidson once again keeps it for himself, breaking to the outside, breaks to the 47-yard line where he is taken down. And with 20.8 seconds left, we see Elizabeth Forward call another timeout to stop the clock.
Yeah, Jaquan Davidson using his speed to his advantage. I don't think they took a timeout, though, Cody. They're going to let the chains move and use that time to their advantage. So the clock stops, and they're going to go ahead and spike the ball as well, Cody, and go ahead and stop the clock there. 15.8 seconds left.
Yeah, that's saves the timeout, Tyler. That's a very smart move by the Warriors. They have time for maybe about two or three more plays if they use their timeouts efficiently or if they get out of bounds, I would imagine. And granted that one play doesn't carry out too long, they've got about 47 yards to go before they can reach the goal line plane and threaten to score again, which is what they really want to do after this first half and the way it's gone for them. Davidson keeps him for himself, rolling to the outside. He gets to the 40, to the 30, and he's out of bounds at the 30-yard line with 7.7 seconds left. Elizabeth Forward looks like they'll have time for one more play.
One more play, but you got a lot of offensive weapons, Cody. So they're going to go ahead. I would imagine the chains are going to move here. Let's see what they decide to do. If I were them, I'd actually call maybe the timeout. They're going to save it maybe for he ran out of bounds, so the clock just automatically stops. I don't know why I wouldn't think that automatically. But nonetheless, Jaquan Davidson, a lot of weapons on offense. He's one of them. He's going to look to put the ball in the end zone here.
Davidson in the shotgun. Three receivers to the right looking to pass. Rolls to his right. The pass is long. It is caught in the end zone for a touchdown for Elizabeth Forward. No, it is incomplete. Oh, that fooled me. It was wide open in the back of the end zone, and the ball got dropped for an incomplete pass as time expires here in the first half. The score remains 13-7 in favor of Belle Vernon.
Walter Myers, I don't know. He just dropped right through his hands, Cody, right through the breadbasket. It looks like a chipmunk might have come up, bit a hole through the middle, but that's going to be the end of the first half, Cody.
Stay tuned for halftime coverage here on CUTV's High School Football Game of the Week. After one half of play, your score reads Belle Vernon 13, Elizabeth Forward 7.
Need to know what's happening in your area? CUTV News Center brings you your best local news. Events on and around campus. Local weather. Vulcan sports coverage. CUTV News Center, live Thursdays at 5.
Explore new worlds. Read. Visit literacy.gov and let the journey begin.
Now, some action from the courts. Billie Jean King renewing her rivalry with arthritis. First set, furious volley, and right to the net for a winner. Beautiful forehand there. Arthritis, stunned. And here, match point. Billie Jean with the ace, taking it in straight sets. Afterwards, a jubilant Billie Jean King.
Tennis is a weapon for me with arthritis. There's nothing like it for me to hit a ball, run to the ball, anytime. Any court, I'm ready. Let's go.
What's your weapon against arthritis? Find out at fightarthritispain.org.
Watch CUTV online anytime, anywhere. Check out your favorite original programs, coverage of the biggest events on campus, and cheer on your Vulcan sports teams. CUTV, log on. Tune in now. Visit cutv.calu.edu/live.
And welcome back to CUTV's coverage of High School Football Game of the Week between the Belle Vernon Leopards and the Elizabeth Forward Warriors. Your score reads 13-7. It is halftime here at Warrior Stadium. You are now seeing the Belle Vernon Marching Band, and after that you will see the Elizabeth Forwards Marching Band perform their shows. So enjoy, and stay tuned for the second half.
Yeah. have quarterback at Fitz once.
Well, Fitz, you know, his brother was the kid from, remember that kid that was in Duquesne, Elijah Fields, and played for Fitz? But he ended up, I think it's his cousin. It might be cousin. It might be his cousin. But, you know, I think, I don't know if he was a rich, he's from over West, that listed way. I don't know if he moved here or whatever.
Okay.
What? This one's for Hebrew. Points in the second half?
Yeah.
Mary,
never know.
Justin's calling.
never, even when we were 1-9 or 9-1, we never got blown out. We couldn't score points. Because the first year Mark Smith broke his hand, it was all like an Elier quarterback. I just think the coach wasn't good. He didn't put us in 16. Chesky used to try to put everybody man-on-man power football. If we weren't big enough. We needed to cross blocks. Things changed quick.
If Garrett was here, you think he'd lose the game yet?
Cecilia Lee Alger and Steve Welsh. Cecilia, raised by Rebecca Lee and Mark Alger. Cecilia is a member of the TFC Cross Country Team.
Coach, this is the best game he's coached. He's running. Because Travis is there, he just thought he had it. But the best thing he did for Travis was only let him throw 12, 15 times a game. 12 times, play action, run the ball. Because guess what Travis was doing? He'd probably be 9 for 12, 10 for 12 for him. And he throw for his 150 yards. You know what I'm saying? But he got all things pretty good. It ain't fast. They're not big. They're really not even fast. You got one speed guy. You ain't putting him in motion. Pittsburgh recruiting them taller knee backs too, you know? Hey, how good was Clarkson last year? All three of them are playing already. How good were they? One kid's playing almost started safety. One kid's, he's a quarterback half the game. Tyler Boyd's unbelievable. Didn't play wide receiver in high school. Boy, he can catch a ball, huh? He just, you know, like that scene, there's just six guys in the box. And he gets to them and he don't get touched on them. He just, he got that gear, you know? That Florida State game wasn't as bad as people make it out. The defense was a little bit off too much. On the offense, though, it wasn't that bad. You have freshman running backs, and they ran actually pretty good. First time, you know, the kid hasn't played in, 4 years since he was a Rutgers. That dude right there, you're underneath Chris, you might get an NFL. That Savage might get an NFL tryout. They didn't have him for a couple years back. You gotta see him power the ball now.
His future plans are undecided at this time. Rachel Pasco and Sam Bowen.
I guess it's his home.
She's also a member of the FIM and And in 2013, homecoming king, Mr. Cameron Baychak. And our 2013 queen, Ms. Mackenzie Marshall.
CUTV is your home for local high school football action. Sundays at 8:30, Thursdays at 5:30, only on CUTV.
If you drive buzzed, it could cost you around $10,000. You'll face major legal fees, major fines, and steep insurance penalties. You could lose everything. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Something's not right.
My first symptoms were
constant tingling in my toes.
I had double vision.
They said you have multiple sclerosis.
Kind of had to get a grasp on reality.
I had to adapt and change very rapidly.
I had to learn how to drive with my hands. Yeah, that was interesting.
A symptom may cause you not to be able to do that anymore. And at one point, I wasn't able to do any of those.
Since I've been cycling, it's definitely helped my walking.
It's a fantastic opportunity to be working together with a common goal of curing MS. And sharing is the key.
Watch CUTV online anytime, anywhere. Check out your favorite original programs. Coverage of the biggest events on campus. And cheer on your Vulcan sports teams. CUTV. Log on. Tune in now. Visit cutv.calu.edu/live.
And welcome back to CUTV's coverage of high school football game of the week. The second half is just about to get underway from Warrior Stadium here in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania. And Tyler, we had quite a first half, if I may say. Let's take a look at some stats.
Yes, you take a look at the rushing totals. Belle Vernon taking the advantage now of a passing dead even at 11.
106 yards of total offense for Belle Vernon. That's where they take over. But three turnovers for Elizabeth Ford has really hurt them so far. But the penalties on the opposite side for Belle Vernon hurting them. Nine penalties for 70 yards. But nonetheless, Belle Vernon able to still be on top as of halftime. 13-7, but Cody, it's been a great game.
It has been. It has been really tight game here so far. The halftime festivities are just about to conclude, and we are about to see Elizabeth Forward receive the opening kick. But first, let's take a look at how we got here in the first half. We have some highlights for you.
As you see that one, that's the opening kickoff return there by Belle Vernon. On that one, I believe it was number 20. That's Derek Flerkleeren. I keep unpronouncing that name correctly, but it's a tough one. Nonetheless, there's the freshman quarterback there for Belle Vernon, finding his open receiver, Jake Schweitzer. He's a senior. He's showing his, you know, why he's a senior there. He's 6'4", also size to his advantage, Cody.
Yeah, and he was stopped just short of the touchdown there, but Belle Vernon did go on to score later on in that drive. That was their second touchdown of the game, and now we'll see Belle Vernon kick off to start the second half here at Warrior Stadium. Elizabeth Forward to receive. It is Bernadowski. He's at the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, breaking away, 50, 45, 40. Is it the 30? He's at the 20. He's at the 10. One guy to beat. It is a touchdown for Elizabeth Forward. Bernadowski striking first here for Elizabeth Forward in the second half. 13 all pending the extra point.
Bernadowski literally plotted out his route. If you take a look at the replay, oh, there he is running away with it there, having one to beat. That was the kicker, and he defeated him very well. But he very slowly approached the blockers, Cody, and then he took off, found an open hole up the middle. Great job by the special teams of Elizabeth Ford to create that hole. Took right up the middle. He was untouched the entire way.
Yeah, it was a perfect run for Bernadowski, and just like how we saw Belle Vernon return the opening kickoff for a touchdown, we see Elizabeth Forward do the same thing to start the second half of this game. Elizabeth Forward could take the lead with this extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Elizabeth Forward takes the first lead of the night by 1 point. Score is 14-13. You are watching CUTV's High School Football Game of the Week. Here on CUTV, more second half action coming up next.
Watch CUTV online anytime, anywhere. Check out your favorite original programs, coverage of the biggest events on campus, and cheer on your Vulcan sports team. CUTV. Log on. Tune in now. Visit cutv.calu.edu/live. You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
And welcome back to Warrior Stadium in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania, for CUTV's High School Football Game of the Week. We just saw Elizabeth Forward return the first kick of the second half for a touchdown, and now we see Belle Vernon return their first kick to the 33-yard line where they will set up shop for their first drive of the second half.
Bernadowski has really been an impact player for Elizabeth Forward, Cody, showing so far in this game. Two big touchdowns, one fumble, but nonetheless making up for it on defense as well. He's really that impact player that Elizabeth Forward really relies on, and he's a standout not only on the field just because of his plays, but his socks as well. He's coming off the field. He looks to be limping, surprisingly. Something seems to be wrong. Hopefully for Elizabeth Forward, that's not game-ending. But nonetheless, Belle Vernon looks to take advantage of that missing man on offense.
It will be first and 10 from the 33. Two receivers to the left and one man back for Fine, who is in the shotgun. It looks like it's Fine from up here, and it is Fine. He takes it up the middle, breaks to the outside, hands it off, and it is a gain of 1 yard. It will be second down and 9 from the 34.
Berkleeren on the carry on that one, takes it to the outside, tries to go up the middle first. As you see here, he gets stood up straight, but able to bounce off that defenseman and able to get off another defenseman too. Gets a few extra yards after the touch on that one. And that'll give him 1 yard. All that fighting for just 1 yard, but nonetheless, 1 yard can make a difference.
11 minutes and 5 seconds left to go in the third quarter. We're just underway here, second half action. In the shotgun, takes it up the middle, and it is a gain of about 6 more yards. It will be third down and short, relatively short, from the 40-yard line.
Mike Fine keeps it himself on that one, Cody. Good quarterback keep. He saw an open hole up the middle. As you take a look here and see it, great job by the center, able to get the pancake on that one, flatten out the defensive lineman, put him down on his back, open up a nice hole for Fine to run up, and he got some necessary yards out of that 8 yards, third and one for the Leopards.
Third down and about 2 yards to go for Belle Vernon. We see Fine in the shotgun, but keeps it for himself, taking it up the middle for enough first down yardage, but there is a flag on the play. Pending the first down, the penalty could be pushing this one back, and they might have to redo third down.
I actually didn't see any penalties on that one, Cody. We'll see what the referees are discussing here, picking up the flags, but I'm not sure if that means anything or not. It looks like it's actually going to be maybe taken away. It's going to be a face mask on the Warriors. It's going to be a 5-yard face mask, so not as bad, but we'll take it, see if we can see it on the replay here. As Fine takes it up the left side. Very slight grab of the face mask on that one. I see what the ref saw. His helmet did jerk down a little bit, so good call on the referees to notice just that little bit of hand in the face mask.
Fine is in the shotgun. He keeps it for himself, rolling out to the near side. Now back up the middle. There's another flag on the play. He's taken down and around the line of scrimmage for a minimal loss, pending the penalty.
We've seen a lot of yellow flags being thrown from the pockets of the referees today, Cody. So the penalties haven't seduced any at all, and it's actually going to be a holding call on Belle Vernon. So that hurts them again. That's 10 penalties on the day for them for a total of 80 yards. 80 yards of penalties is a lot, Cody.
That is, and especially with 9:56 left to go in the third quarter, having 80 yards that soon is a very large number. Belle Vernon looking to turn things around here, hopefully for their sake, because Elizabeth Forward has taken their first lead of the game, and Elizabeth Forward just doing all that they can to stop it. Two receivers to the left and one man back. Fine is in the shotgun. It is a running back direct snap, and it takes up the far side for a gain of about 5 yards. It will be second down and about 17.
Pending the fumble, Cody, we'll see who comes up with it. It is Belle Vernon's recovery. Not able to hold on to it for clearing. Comes up with a fumble on that one, but luckily for Belle Vernon's sake, they hold on to it. We'll take to see, look at the replay to see if we can notice anything. And that ball was stripped, Cody, I believe. It was stripped there by number 7 for the Warriors. Number 7 is Billy Miles, a good defensive standout for the team so far. Haven't called his name so much on offense, but doing a good job on defense nonetheless.
And it is very fortunate for Belle Vernon to recover after Elizabeth Forward got that opening half touchdown. There's more flags on the play as some linemen appear to be jumping early. It will be a false start call against Belle Vernon, and they will move back 5 more yards to make it second down and 21.
That is now 11 penalties for 85 yards for the Leopards. So, I mean, penalties are really killing them so far, almost the entire length of the field, getting pretty close to it at least. So they really got to try to tame that a little bit because, I mean, 80 additional yards on offense for Belle Vernon can help you out so much, Cody. Possibly even put another couple points on the board, 6th, 7th, even 3 helps. That keeps you in the lead. It's only a 1-point game.
Fine under center. He looks to pass, but he is hurried and sacked, and the ball comes loose. Elizabeth Forward stumbling upon it. 2 players fall on it. Who will be on the recovery? That is up to the officials to decide. Elizabeth Forward looked like they might have had control. And boy, if they have control, that would be a huge opportunity.
The fumble is recovered by Elizabeth Forward. Can't see who came up with it on that one. It looks like it might have been Wardrop or number 25. And man, that is great field position for Elizabeth Forward, Cody. You're right inside this 14-yard line. great job to recover that fumble. Almost wasn't able to. Almost Bell Vernon's ball. We'll take a look at the replay here. There's the official fumble. There's the Elizabeth Ford player going after it, but stumbling to do so. The Belle Vernon player doing the same thing, but I believe it was number 25, Wardropper, on the recovery. So good job by Elizabeth Ford getting good field position here. Maybe put some more points up on the board and get a better lead over the Leopards.
Elizabeth Ford have been having a little bit of trouble with the fumbles here in this game. Or excuse me, Belle Vernon, I apologize. Got that backwards. Davidson keeps it for himself, coming to the near side. He's at the 15, he's at the 10, and he goes out of bounds at around the 9-yard line, stopping the clock at 7 minutes and 51 seconds.
Yeah, good job by the quarterback there. Again, Jaquan Davidson turning up the sideline, looking for the pass, just couldn't see the defender open. Good job by Belle Vernon to play strong defense, play good man coverage. But good job by Davidson trying to get as many yards as possible before going out of bounds. That puts you within the 10-yard line, and that puts you in better field position.
Davidson in the shotgun. The ball is snapped. It is a draw up the middle that fails and gets stopped at the 10-yard line for a loss of about 1 yard. It will be third down and 6 for the Warriors.
It looks like that running back, Jalen French, on the carry, not able to get away from the Belle Vernon defense on that one. Tried his hardest, though. Tried to keep the feet moving and keep up on his feet, but it'll push him back a little bit to the 11-yard line. It's going to be interesting to see what happens on this third down, Cody.
They are in great field position regardless of what happens here after the turnover. Davidson rolling out to the far side, going to keep it for himself. He's got enough for the first down, but does he have enough for the touchdown? Referee is signaling touchdown, but there is a flag on the play.
I believe that's going to be a face mask, but I believe that's going to be declined as well. I saw the head torque on Davidson, so I believe the defender might have grabbed a little bit of face mask. But we'll see what the referees decide. I believe that's going to be the call, though, Cody.
Should the penalty be against Belle Vernon, you would guess that Elizabeth Forward would decline and take the result of the play, which would be the touchdown.
It's actually going to be against Elizabeth Forward, Cody. I didn't see what it was. I'm assuming it was going to be a holding call because they did move back. Legal block in the back. We'll see the replay, though, to see where it's at. Not seeing anything here.
Third and 6 for the Warriors.
I don't know, Cody. It could have been anything. I mean, obviously it was an illegal block in the back, but I didn't see where it might have been at. Unfortunate for the Warriors, though, looking like they might have just put 6 more points on the board, but instead got nothing.
Davidson passes to the near side to Bernadowski. Bernadowski is in the end zone for a touchdown for the Elizabeth Forward Warriors. 20-13, pending the extra point. Elizabeth Forward strikes again here in the second half.
I want to know where Bernadowski takes his dance classes at, Cody. Honestly, you look at the footwork that this young man has. As you take a look at the replay, a nice wide receiver screen to Bernadowski. Goes to the right, breaks the ankles of the defender. Keeps to the left, goes through a couple more defenders, able to shed right through them, uses speed to his advantage. That's a touchdown all day, Cody.
And it does look really good how he's able to break all those tackles. You know, we saw 3 or 4 defenders slip right through him, and the extra point is up, and the extra point is good. With 7 minutes and 5 seconds left to go in the third quarter, your score reads Elizabeth Forward 21, Belle Vernon 13. Stay tuned for more action of High School Football Game of the Week on CUTV.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of the child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 110. I'm Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism.
Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
Welcome back to Warrior Stadium here in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania. It is 7 minutes and 5 seconds left in the third quarter, but there was a personal foul call on the previous play, Tyler. It will be reinforced on the kick here. So your score reading 21-13, Elizabeth Forward really making a name for themselves in this second half.
Yes, they are. Unnecessary roughness call late after that last play, so it'll go tackle onto the kickoff. And that one, again, it was against Belle Vernon. So the kickoff will be commenced from Belle Vernon's 45-yard line. Surely that should push him way past, possibly into the end zone. But we'll see how the kick goes here, Cody.
Elizabeth Forward kicking off to Belle Vernon. Here's the kick. It is a short one, as you would guess. It goes into the end zone, where it will be a touchback for Belle Vernon, and they will set up shop at the 20-yard line.
Now's the time for Belle Vernon to start getting some momentum back on your side. You had it early in the first half. Now you have to reestablish it here in the second half. You disallowed Elizabeth Forward to put 14 unanswered points on the board. So you have to do something here in order to stop that from happening, because you don't want to let a team like Elizabeth Forward, who's currently third in the Big Nine, try to build any more momentum getting that closer to that top spot.
Yeah, this game is proving to be very vital for both of these teams in a lot of aspects. And it's been tight, really, all game, as we see running back take it up the middle, where we will be stopped at the line of scrimmage for no gain on the play. The ball does come loose, but the referees are signaling him down at the 20-yard line. It will be second down and 10.
Yeah, as you take a handoff like that, you definitely want to make sure you want to hold on to the ball as much as possible. You see the replay has both arms on it, driving through, and it looks like he will go down before the ball comes out. Defense doing a good job, at least trying to strip the ball away, trying to get another possession, and have it in good field position as well.
Yeah, Elizabeth Forward really trying to add on to their lead. This is the first lead. They didn't have a lead until the second half, so they're really standing strong here on defense as we see another run get stopped at the line of scrimmage. It will be third down and 10 for Belle Vernon here at their own 20-yard line.
It just seems like Belle Vernon really lost their pep in their step, Cody. Just coming out kind of flat now on offense. Hopefully their defense doesn't show the same signs, because that's going to even be worse. But Belle Vernon needs something to happen for them right now. A good third down conversion here would be great, but they need to get something moving.
5 minutes and 37 seconds left to go in the third quarter. It is third down and 10 for Belle Vernon. Fine is under center. Here's the snap. He's looking to pass. The pass is going to not happen as he gets sacked at the 10-yard line. Elizabeth Forward's defense really coming through, forcing a fourth down for Belle Vernon.
Great defensive stand there for Elizabeth Forward, able to contain that Belle Vernon offense and not allow Mike Fine to do anything productive. He had a couple open receivers, but just pressured from the very get-go. Just doing the smart thing, holding on to it, not allowing another turnover, another interception like he did earlier in the game. Just holding on to it, taking the sack, and they're going to try to start over from scratch next possession.
Belle Vernon will be punting from their own 1-yard line is where the punter stands. And here's the punt. It is a line drive punt to Bernadowski. He fields it at the 48-yard line, takes a couple juke steps. He breaks away to the outside and stops at the 40-yard line, where the defenders are able to bring him down.
There's a great block there by Jalen French on that play. Well, let's go ahead, and we're going to go ahead and announce our CUTV booth tweet of the week. If you tweet us at CUTV_PA and use the hashtag CUTV booth, you have a chance to have your tweet read online on the air. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at the tweet of the week, and it is from @Allie Steinhauser. EF needs to pull away from the pack in the Big Nine and have a chance to compete with Thomas Jefferson and West Mifflin in conference standing. So I definitely agree with that. It's a tough conference to be in, the Big Nine. I mean, the two standouts year after year, Thomas Jefferson and West Mifflin. So you definitely need to separate yourselves if you're Elizabeth Forward.
Here's the reverse to Bernadowski, and Bernadowski breaking away to the 30, to the 20, to the 10. It is a touchdown for Elizabeth Forward. Bernadowski once again providing six more points for the Warriors, 27-13, pending the extra point.
Cody, if I'm not mistaken, I think you're going to see Matt Bernadowski on every play of the week this week on High School Roundup, honestly. This kid is impressive. Look at this fake handoff. The defense was so confused, a few of them caught on, but Bernadowski able to use his juke work, and number one there on the block, Anthony Brown, good job. Stiff arms the last defender before he gets into the end zone. Bernadowski tearing up on offense right now.
4 minutes and 21 seconds left to go in the quarter. The extra point kick is up, and it is just barely good. Elizabeth Forward now with 21 unanswered points in this second half, with 4:21 left in the third. Elizabeth Forward, 28, and Belle Vernon, 13. You are watching CUTV's High School Football Game of the Week. Stay tuned for the conclusion of the third quarter.
Think you found every hazard out here today? Think again. The spot you missed could be a killer. That spot on your skin could be skin cancer. If you're a man over 50, you're in a group most likely to develop skin cancer, including melanoma, the kind that kills one person every hour. That's why your best shot is to check for a spot. It's easy. Follow through and check your skin. Go to spotskincancer.org to find out how. A message from the American Academy of Dermatology.
You are watching CUTV, California University Television.
Nice round of applause for the young man.
Welcome back to Warrior Stadium here in Elizabeth Forward, Pennsylvania. 4 minutes and 21 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Elizabeth Forward with 21 unanswered points in this second half. Tyler, we're seeing this team really come out of the gate here early on in the second half and really making a name for themselves.
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the replay of this last play, Cody. And Bernadowski, I mean, just burns the defense, really. He takes it up the left side, gets a great block there from Brown. Stiff arms the last defender, takes it himself into the end zone. Bernadowski is a senior, so you're wondering for the rest of the year how big of a weapon he's going to be for this team. How well he's going to stand out and how well he's going to help this team overall, not only in the conference, but like I said, he's a senior, Cody. So you wonder where he might go after high school. He might go D2, he might go D1. You don't know. I mean, his fate is in his own hands. So
the kick is a squib. It goes retrieved at the 30-yard line to the 40, where it is brought down at around the 39, 38-yard line. And that is where Belle Vernon will set up shop with 4:15 left to go in the third.
Yeah, trick plays are definitely essential. I wouldn't even call them trick plays, Cody. Just a couple play actions. Something to keep the defense on their heels. As you saw in that last touchdown play, you don't know where the pitch is going. There's so many weapons on offense, so much speed to go to. You got Jalen French. You got Jaquan Davidson able to keep it himself. And then you got Bernadowski to pitch to as well. Not to mention the receiver, Anthony Brown. A lot of weapons on offense for Elizabeth Ford. They're utilizing them very well.
One receiver on each side. Fine is under center. He hands it off. Trying to break to the outside, but is stopped early on and is stopped for a two-yard loss by the Elizabeth Forward defense.
Ryan Wardropper on the tackle on that play. Unfortunately for Bradley Sloan, he's not able to get away from Wardropper. As you take a look, it's a great tackle. Honestly, just grabs his hips and drives him down like a lion would on a gazelle. Doing a great job on defense. Elizabeth Ford is rolling right now, Cody.
Yeah, on both sides of the ball, both the defensive and the offensive sides. Fine with two men back and one to his left. There's some play action, looking to pass. The pass is tipped into the air, and it falls incomplete right at the 40-yard line. It was almost picked off by several Elizabeth Forward defenders, but it fell to the ground just too soon.
Almost a great tip drill play there. As you see, the player for Elizabeth Forward a little upset on that one. French But you'll take a look at the replay. Fine going out, rolling out on the play action.
We have third and 12 for Belle Vernon.
And somebody gets their hands on it there. That's number seven for Elizabeth Ford, Billy Miles. And the tip drill almost completed, but just not enough to get there after all.
Belle Vernon looks at a third down and 12 here at the 38-yard line of their own end, and we have a stoppage in play here. I believe it will be a timeout called by Belle Vernon. And Tyler, you know, Elizabeth Forward here, they really could be intimidating this Belle Vernon team. It really seems like on both sides of the ball. We just saw two runs try to go, and they were stopped really early on, and we saw the 21 unanswered points. It's a big battle here.
But as far as upcoming telecasts go, Cody, September 24th, Falcon Soccer, women's soccer, that is, facing Pitt Johnstown. September 27th, more high school football action coming your way as we get to go watch Deer Lakes take on Charleroi at Charleroi. And, of course, September 28th, the Cold Bowl commences, California against Indiana. It's always a good one. This will be the fifth year of it, Cody. California leads the series overall. Big rivalry at D2. It's always great to see.
California will be traveling to IUP this year for the annual Cole Bowl game. And you're right, Tyler. It's a fantastic game to watch, a fantastic rivalry in Division II football. It's definitely a great game to watch, and we look forward to bringing you the coverage on CUTV.
Last year's game, Cody, was absolutely phenomenal. Big comeback for California late in the game, able to seal the deal and defeat their rivalry, IUP, the Crimson Hawks. So definitely a game that you want to keep your eyes on.
Fine was in the shotgun, but there's a flag on the play, and the whistle blows the play dead. We'll see what the penalty is. It will be a false start call against Belle Vernon, and they will march back five more yards for a third and 17.
Again, penalties killing Belle Vernon. Just continues to happen. 3:24 left in the third quarter, Cody. I'm just impressed. I'm not impressed. I'm surprised. By the way, Belle Vernon's team has really just been committing so many penalties, really hurting them this game. That could really keep them in this game if they weren't committing so many.
Three receivers to the right and one to the left and one man back for Fine, who is in the shotgun, and he looks to pass. The pass is thrown, and it falls incomplete in and out of the hands of the defensive back for Elizabeth Forward. Clock stops with 3 minutes and 17 seconds left to go.
A lot of confusion there on defense for Elizabeth Forward. A couple of the players not sure where to go. I was expecting maybe Belle Vernon to take advantage of it, but just couldn't do it. Overall, really good coverage, even though Elizabeth Forward wasn't exactly sure what was going on. Good job by Elizabeth Forward's defense to kind of redeem themselves and force the punt here on fourth down.
Fourth down and 17. Belle Vernon looking to punt. Punt team is on the field, and we'll see Elizabeth Forward regain control here possibly. Here's the punt. The punt is going to take a roll to the 20-yard line where Elizabeth Forward will be starting their offensive drive here with 3:06 left to go in the third.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at that Big Nine Conference again. West Mifflin on top overall, 3-0. Thomas Jefferson, one less divisional game. Elizabeth Forward, one game behind Thomas Jefferson and West Mifflin. Ringgold, always a tough team, tied with Elizabeth Forward in the rankings right now. Albert Gallatin, Belle Vernon there making up your middle. Then you got Uniontown, Trinity, and Laurel Highlands still struggling with that 0-3 start. Laurel Highlands really doing a good job, though, at least trying to rebuild their system, rebuild their program. It's always tough, but nonetheless, they're doing a good job of it, performing better as weeks continue.
Elizabeth Forward will set up shop from their own 21-yard line. Davidson is in the shotgun. Bernadowski gets sent in motion, and there's some play action. The fake, the handoff to Bernadowski, and Davidson keeps it for himself to the 25-yard line for a gain of about four.
Gain about seven on the play. It's second and three for the Warriors.
You see, Davidson keeps it himself on this play, and that's a good job. It's a really good convincing fake, actually. Except Bernadowski kind of didn't make sense of where he was going, didn't have a good sense of direction there, but Davidson able to get quite a few yards on that carry. Davidson, again, showing that he can not only do it with his arm, but with his legs as well.
Here's some more play action. Davidson once again keeping it for himself at the 40. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. One guy to beat. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And it is another Elizabeth forward touchdown. 34-13 pending the extra point, Tyler, with 2 minutes and 19 seconds. Davidson on that touchdown there. We saw the play action really fool the defense there.
That it did. And Davidson really proving me right on that one. Getting a great block there from Wardropper, the running back on that play. Able to take care of business on the block. But Davidson using his legs, using his speed to his advantage there. Gets another 6 points up on the board for Elizabeth Forward. Everything really working in the favor of the Warriors now.
So far, so good for this Warrior team. Really, that something happened in that locker room at halftime that really made them step up their game and put up a lot of unanswered points. Here's the extra point kick. The kick is up, and the kick is good. 2 minutes and 19 seconds are remaining here in the third quarter. At that point in time, Elizabeth Forward 35, Belle Vernon 13. You are watching High School Football Game of the Week on CUTV.
Explore new worlds. Read. Visit literacy.gov and let the journey begin.
You're watching CUTV, California University Television.
And welcome back to Warrior Stadium, where we see Elizabeth Forward now put up 28 unanswered points, Tyler, coming out of the gate in this second half. And I feel like I feel like a broken record really saying this, but they're standing out really strong here in this second half. The kick is a squib to Belle Vernon, where it is retrieved at the 18-yard line and will be stopped at around the 40-yard line. That is where Belle Vernon will start their drive with 2:08 left to go in the third quarter.
Cody Mench is on the return on that one. Good job keeping his legs rolling, not allowing the play to end. He got actually like an additional 5 yards on that carry from the time where he met the defenders and the blockers. So, I mean, good job keeping the legs rolling. You look for that kind of play in a player. You look for that kind of fight. And Belle Vernon still has some fight left in him, but if they're looking to fight on the scoreboard here and contend with Elizabeth Forward, they've got to do something on offense on this drive, Cody. 2:08 left in the third. You got to make something happen soon.
And Belle Vernon's definitely looking to do that here on this offensive drive. There's a flag on the play, whistling the play dead before it even began. It will be a false start penalty against Belle Vernon, and they will back up 5 more yards.
Again, penalties killing. I feel like a broken record now, Cody, because penalties have just been killing Belle Vernon. Very unfortunate. But there's like a haze setting over the stadium now, Cody. Very humid atmosphere. That could mean that weather is coming in stronger weather. A lot of rain expected in the forecast within this weekend, about 2 inches of rain projected. So hopefully that doesn't happen to conclude this game. We like to stay dry here.
And that we do. 2 receivers to the left, 1 man back. Fine keeps it for himself, trying to break to the outside, but is stopped up the middle for a loss of about a couple yards or so. It will be second down and about 18 from the 30-yard line.
Fine actually took a really hard hit there. I was surprised not to see a flag. If you take a look at the replay here, he almost got German suplex, if you will, by the defense. Number 58. Oh, he actually fumbled the ball too, able to hold on to it there. Number 58. For Elizabeth Forward is Brandon Janicki. Good job, you know, making the tackle, forcing the fumble, but very, very tough tackle for Fine to take.
Just under 90 seconds left to go in this third quarter. Belle Vernon looking to strike back and cut into Elizabeth Forward's lead. Here's the pitch to the outside. It goes to the 35-yard line where It will be stopped, and it will be third down and long for Belle Vernon.
Sloan again on the carry there. Doing a good job going to the right side, working with what he had. Actually, no, that wasn't Sloan again. I keep messing up on the running backs. For Clearing, though, on the carry on that one. Showing a lot of pizzazz, at least, with his speed. Getting a nice, tough run. Doing a nice, tough run.
45 seconds left to go in this third quarter. Two receivers to the left, two to the right, and there's one man back, and we have a stoppage in play. It will be a timeout taken by Elizabeth Forward.
Timeout.
Yeah, I like what Elizabeth Forward did there. They didn't like exactly what they were showing on defense compared to what the offense was showing, so they wanted to take a minute to kind of reassess what was going on. They didn't know if maybe Belle Vernon was going to try to make something happen here on third down, or maybe if they were just going to kind of throw in a towel. But nonetheless, Cody, CUTV has a Facebook page. You can check out our Facebook page. Again, it's California University Television. Just search it and go through it and try to find it. And be a part of the broadcast. You know, give us your insight on what we do. Give us some comments. If you have any questions, we'll be sure to answer them. Check out some of our programming, too. Sometimes we lay out some polls on there for you to answer as well. So give us your insight. Give us your feedback. We want to know how we're doing and how we're pleasing you guys.
There's a lot of user interaction on the Facebook page, and that is exactly what social media is intended for, at least on California University Television's page. We certainly like to hear your feedback and like for you to participate in the polls and everything else in between. 39 and a half seconds are left in the third quarter. It is a third and 13 for Belle Vernon. The ball is snapped. Fine is looking to pass. He is hurried. Breaks away and gets taken down at the 35. It will be fourth down and long for Belle Vernon here. And they will, looks like they'll be able to run the clock out. That might be what they do, Tyler, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, they're not looking to get it on offense here. I'm actually surprised. It kind of just shows you maybe that they're kind of done fighting. If I'm Belle Vernon, I'm not giving up in this thing yet. This game is very important as far as the conference standings goes, Cody. I would try to at least get another play in before letting the quarter go to waste. But, Cody, something that we do here at CUTV is a hot dog score. Okay, as you take a look at the graphic here, 35-13, Elizabeth Ford leading. But, again, going back to the hot dog score, It's a tradition that we have here at CUTV. We go to all these stadiums, and we like to go to the concession stands as well and try out the food. Usually we go with the hot dogs. However, we also go for the other delicious treats that some stadiums might have, with fried Oreos, fried dough, mozzarella sticks, cheese fries. Whatever we're feeling that day, we go after, Cody.
And today it was the deep-fried Oreos, Tyler, and may I say that score was absolutely amazing.
It had to have been, because it's a 9.6, Cody. It was one of the best deep-fried Oreos I've personally ever had, Cody. And I've had a lot of deep-fried Oreos in my day. Okay, I'm a professional deep-fried Oreo eater, if you could say. I mean, but it was a delicious, delicious deep-fried Oreo. But let's see how that ranks. It's actually not as good as the California Trojans hot dogs at Trojan Field there. But 9.6 is a respectable score there, coming in close second. But Good deep-fried Oreos. Good concessions here at Warrior Stadium.
They were some of the best deep-fried Oreos that I ever had, too, and it's going to take a lot to top that. But the fourth quarter is just about to get underway with Belle Vernon's punt to Elizabeth Forward. It bounces to the 30, takes an Elizabeth Forward bounce, rolls, and stops at the 21-yard line. And that is where Elizabeth Forward will set up shop to begin the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Elizabeth Forward doesn't have great field position to work with, but nonetheless, it's not terrible. But the coaches here for Elizabeth Forward are very good coaches nonetheless. Head coach Mike Ladone takes over again in 2012, takes over being a coach. He coached here beforehand in years prior in the 1990s and such. Really enjoyed the program, so he decided to come back. And so far, he said he had a 5-year plan to get this team back in the top of the Big Nine Conference. He's been around for two, and they're, you know, top three as of right now. So good job by Ladone.
The defense is drawn off sides, but it looks like it will be a false start penalty against Elizabeth Forward.
First against Belle Vernon, 5-yard penalty.
Oh, no, I apologize. It was against Belle Vernon. It was an encroachment call, and it will be first down and 5 for Elizabeth Forward.
Jaquan Davidson very, very convincing on that one on the fake snap. Caught his whole body into it, really drew that defensive line off.
It's first down and 5 for Elizabeth Forward. Davidson keeps it for himself, running up the middle. He is stopped at the 31-yard line. He will be just short of the first down marker, or so it would seem, and it will be second down and very short for Elizabeth Forward.
Second and short. It's going to be 11:30 left here in the fourth quarter. As you saw the replay on that one, very, very close to the first down. Actually, they're going to give it to him. They decided that he did get far enough. That'll give the Warriors the first down and a much-needed one for the Warriors. But if you're Belle Vernon, you didn't want to see that happen at all.
Now, I'm sure they would have liked to stop him short, but unfortunately it falls in Elizabeth Forward's favor for Belle Vernon's sake. And it will be first down and 10 from the 31-yard line. The first down marker will be moved to the 41-yard line. Davidson is in the shotgun. Snap is a draw up the middle, and it will be a gain of about 2 yards to the 38-yard line, or 33-yard line, excuse me. Just under 11 minutes left to go in this fourth quarter now. Elizabeth Forward hanging on to a 35-13 lead.
Didn't look too promising for Elizabeth Forward when the game took off, Cody. I mean, the opening kickoff for the touchdown and then an additional touchdown on top of that, and then the Warriors coming back with 35 unanswered overall, 28 in the second half alone. Really turning the game around. The student section's loving it. There's a bunch of them standing up down there enjoying this game.
Here's the snap. Davidson hands it off for another draw. It goes up the middle. There's a little bit of a scramble, but it looks like it will be downed at the 35-yard line, and we see a couple flags come in after the play, so there's some extracurricular activity there on that play. Possibly Belle Vernon being frustrated or Elizabeth Forward retaliating. We'll have to see what the call is.
Yeah, this might even be offsetting, Cody. It's hard to say. It looks like both parties might have been guilty. But we'll see what they come up with. It looks like Jalen French might have been one of the guilty people in that one. His coach talking to him right now, trying to control him, kind of calm him down. But again, that Elizabeth Forward student section and cheerleaders both getting into it right now, Cody, really chanting back and forth. It's pretty entertaining to watch.
Yeah, definitely. They're in high spirits after Elizabeth Forward came out of the gate with those 28 points to start the second half. It would fire up any student section in my book.
It looks like this penalty is actually going to go against Elizabeth Forward. Like I said, a lot of coaches really right now trying to talk to Jalen French, trying to calm him down. They don't want this game to get out of hand. So a sportsmanlike conduct penalty. And we'll see on the replay here. There's Jalen French on the carry. Takes it up the middle.
Third down for Warriors.
Might have been frustrated that the whistle was blown. And they were still, you know, trying to tackle him, even though the whistle was dead. He was done playing, but the Belle Vernon defense wasn't. It might have been a little bit of both frustration on each part of the side of the ball.
Here's the snap. It is a handoff to Bernadowski. Bernadowski breaking up the outside. And he stopped at the 29-yard line. It will be fourth down and long for Elizabeth Forward.
Yeah, the punt team's going to come out on the field for this one, Cody. And a smart call that is, because you're up to 35-13 lead. There's no reason to have to go for it on fourth down. Just go ahead and put it away. Trust your defense. Play smart football. That's all it is at this point. 9:30 left in the game. Just rely on your defense. It's been holding strong ever since Belle Vernon scored their last points of the game, which was in the first half.
The punt team takes formation. And the snap is high, but it is caught. Here's the punt. The punt bounces at the 40, rolls to the 30, and goes out of bounds at the 27-yard line. And that is where the officials will mark it. With 9:06 left to go in the game, Belle Vernon taking control.
And you take a look at the remaining high school games coming up. Not the remaining, but the next three at least in line. And the next one being Deer Lakes at Charleroi. Deer Lakes out of the Allegheny Conference. It's a fun time to watch. Teams from a different conference, not from around the area, come down and take on some of the single-A teams from around the area and double-A teams as well. Then we have Best Center at Frazier, which should definitely be a good game. Best Center currently leading their conference after Frazier struggled early, but now coming back to make a strong push. So a lot of good games coming up as far as high school goes, Cody. And if you want to keep in contact, you want to make sure you tune in to CUTV.
We just saw the run play there. Turn up empty for Belle Vernon. It is no gain on the play. It will be second down and 10.
Number 25, Ryan Wardropper. Gain about two on the play. You're at second and 8.
Second and 8, I beg your pardon, according to the PA announcer here at Elizabeth Forward.
Wardropper on the carry, on the tackle, rather. I'm so used to saying he's on the carry. He's been getting a lot of touches tonight, and I'm sure he's been eating it up, and he's been loving every second of it.
Fine is under center with one receiver to each of his sides and two men back. He hands it off, and it goes up the middle. Breaking away moderately is the running back, and he is stopped at the 35-yard line for a gain of about 5, and it will be third down and 4. From the 35-yard line.
Looks like Belle Vernon might be going back to the offense that was proving pretty well for them earlier in the first half, and that is the chip-away offense. He kind of just slowly but surely chip away, use the three downs to your advantage, getting as much little yardage, get the first down. It worked for them in the first half, and I wouldn't be surprised to see him go back to it in the second half just to make this a little bit closer than it is right now.
Fine with the play action. A long pass to the near far side, and it is caught. It is caught at the 35-yard line. A big catch there for Belle Vernon. They are marching down into Elizabeth Forward territory just like that with 7:41 left, looking to cut into the lead.
3 yards for Belle Vernon.
It was only a matter of time till Fine took another attempt downfield, Cody, and he did it there with Menges, on the reception. A great job keeping the ball in control and having a foot down before going out of bounds as well. Try to get Fine some confidence back before his confidence is shot. He is a freshman, so.
Fine is under center. Hands it off and trying to break to the outside but comes up empty. Gets stopped at the 38-yard line for a loss of about 3 yards.
After a big third down conversion on that last play, you kind of take away again, losing 3 yards on that carry. Elizabeth Ford's defense is playing a heck of a game, Cody, and Belle Vernon just not able to figure out how to get past it. In the first half, they were able to all day. They had the momentum in their favor, but now still struggling in the second half. They got to find a way to do it. 7:03 left, Cody.
Fine is once again under center. He's looking to pass. The pass is thrown. The pass is caught at the 34-yard line for a gain of about 4 yards. It will be third down and about 7 from the 34-yard line.
Jake Schweitzer on the reception on that one, your senior tight end. He's been having a good game on offense. I don't understand maybe why you don't try to throw to him a little bit more. Not that they haven't had enough pass attempts or at least attempted to get the ball off, but Elizabeth Ford's defense just able to seal the deal before Fine's able to get the pass off. So Elizabeth Ford making a really tough time there.
Here's the snap. Fine was in the shotgun, and the pass goes overthrown and incomplete. Clock stops at 6 minutes and 17 seconds. And it will be a fourth down for Belle Vernon.
Jaquan Davidson on the batted pass there, even though it was overthrown. Nonetheless, he did get a hand on it. Tried to maybe get the pick before letting the ball travel past his head, but just wasn't able to now. If you're Belle Vernon, you go for it, though. It's 6:17 left in this one. You got to make something happen. A fourth down conversion could prove pretty well for you, and that's what they're going to do. They're going to go for it.
Yeah, fourth down and 8 yards for Belle Vernon. Fine is looking to pass. The pass is long and overthrown, and there's a flag on the play thrown by the back judge.
I'm guessing that's going to be pass interference or maybe even defensive holding on Elizabeth Forward. That might give Belle Vernon a first down on this fourth down play here.
If it is a pass interference call, it will be an automatic first down for Belle Vernon, and it will be inside the red zone if it gets spotted at the spot of the foul. The referee is making sure that everything is correct, as he has been doing all game.
And it looks like it's going to be against Elizabeth Forward. It is pass interference on the defense, and I'm actually surprised to see that call, Cody, because
10-yard penalty.
Actually, it's going to be a holding call, defensive holding, like I said originally. We'll take a look at the replay to see what we can see, Cody. He makes the pass, and there it is right there. He did grab jersey. I don't know if he was in contention of that one in the pros. That might have been a no call, but in the high school level, that's going to be a call all day. So a big break there for the Leopards.
It will be first and 10. Belle Vernon with a fresh set of downs from the 24-yard line of Elizabeth Forward. Two receivers to the left, two to the right, and one man back. Fine is under center. The pass is thrown to the near side, and the pass is caught at the 21-yard line. Falls out of bounds for a gain of 3 yards.
Good job on the tackle there by Wardropper. Able to wrap up a good technical tackle there. Not allowing the tight end, to get away from him again. Number 11 on the reception there is Jake Schweitzer. Now Belle Vernon starting. Belle Vernon led by Mike Fine. Now starting to target Schweitzer a little bit more. Use him, use him to your advantage.
6 minutes and 6 seconds left to go in this game. Fine is under center. Hurried a little bit. The pass is thrown up the middle, and it falls incomplete. We have a stoppage on the clock. It is an incomplete pass.
Yeah, tough job there for the receiver to try to hold on to it. A lot of coverage there from Elizabeth Forward. So, I mean, this defense for Elizabeth Forward really stepping up big now after letting up 13 unanswered points. Stepping up after that, not allowing a point ever since. So, good crushing defense from the Warriors. Being Warriors on the field tonight, they are.
And 7 points of those 13 coming in the opening kickoff of the game. We saw Belle Vernon strike first with that opening kickoff return. Here's the snap. Fine throws it up the middle, and it is caught at the 20-yard line.
Pass is complete, number 11.
5 minutes and 51 seconds left to go in this fourth quarter. It will be fourth down for Belle Vernon and about 7 yards.
Again, Cody, you go for it. You don't go for a field goal here. You definitely try to get the touchdown here. Try to put up at least 6 points. So fourth and 7, you converted once last time, except that was on a penalty. This time you try to convert on maybe a play, but if there's a penalty against Elizabeth Forward, you take that and use it to your advantage. Get as many yards as possible.
Belle Vernon looking for another fourth down conversion here. Finding a shotgun, looking to pass. The pass is long, and the pass is picked off at the 1 yard line, I believe. Or did it fall incomplete, Tyler? I was unable to see if the ball fell through his hands.
I believe it's going to stand as an interception, even though he didn't have full control of it. Whenever he came down with it out of the end zone. Nonetheless, the interception is going to stand. So Elizabeth Ford is going to take the ball at the 1 yard line. That kind of pinned you back a little bit. I think he tried to let go of the ball before he had full possession of it, Cody, because he understood that, man, we're back at the 1 yard line. That's going to hurt us more than it's going to help us. But just not able to do it in time. Anthony Brown there on the interception. So Elizabeth Ford is going to try to put on a 99-yard drive now. It's going to be interesting to see how they do it.
With 5 minutes and 13 seconds left to go, Elizabeth Forward is pressured at their own 1 yard line after the interception. That was Belle Vernon's. Belle Vernon has had multiple turnovers in this game. I believe they have had four or five now. There are flags on the play. It will either be encroachment or false start. I saw both lines jump. It is encroachment on Belle Vernon, so that gives Elizabeth Forward a little bit of breathing room as they move out to their 6 yard line.
Very smart play there by Elizabeth Forward. Knowing that Belle Vernon has committed a lot of penalties in this game, and they've also had many encroachment calls, I would have to guess at least five by now, using that to their advantage, and they did.
It is first and 5 from the 6. The handoff goes up the middle, and it is stopped at the 9-yard line.
More dropper on the carry on that one, Cody. Getting as many yards as he possibly could there. Looks like he gained maybe 2 yards on that one. So it's going to be 2nd and 3 now. I mean, Elizabeth Forward playing a really good sound game. After really the second quarter, they really stepped it up. Played good 3 good quarters of football. With games coming up against West Mifflin and the rest of the Big Nine Conference, this is a good game to definitely work on, and they did well with it.
Both teams have 2 timeouts left. We see Elizabeth Forward pitch it to the far side, and It stops for about a no gain on the play. It will be third down and short for the Warriors with 4:24 left to go in the game.
Now it's just about pretty much running out the clock, Cody, and that's what they're going to do, Elizabeth Forward. It's going to be third and two now. Just run the ball, eat the clock away. You know, use the time clock and use the scoreboard to your advantage. You're up 35-13, 4 minutes left now. Just take, you know, let the time tick. That's about all you can do.
Time is on Elizabeth Forward's side, that's for sure, with a 35-13 lead. Regardless of field position, they definitely have the clock's favor. Here's the handoff. The handoff goes up the middle, and it looks like it will be enough for a first down for the Warriors.
Ryan Wardropper grinding for those couple yards there in order to get the first down, and he was successful in doing so. So another set of downs for Elizabeth Forwards, and you got at least three more downs of play coming up as long as you don't, you know, create another turnover. So it's all about grinding the clock away, Cody.
3 minutes and 40 seconds left to go now here in the fourth quarter. Two receivers to the left, one to the right, two men back. Davidson is under center. Davidson hands it off, running up the gut, taking it to the 25-yard line where he's brought down, and that is enough for another Warrior first down here in this game.
Wardropper using his lead blocks to his advantage there. Had a nice block from the fullback, and he's actually going to sub out now because he's had enough running here. He gained about 20 yards by himself on that drive so far. So using his lead blockers to his advantage, getting the first down, putting some rushing yards in his category and on his resume. It's nice to see that happen, you know?
Yeah, everybody getting a little piece of the action now here in the concluding minutes of this game. We have about 3 minutes left. Davidson hands it off to the fullback. Takes it up the middle to the 34-yard line.
Matt Harrisman taking a handoff. In on attack number 15, Mike Five.
Matt Harrisman taking a handoff there. And it's always nice to see the quarterback hand off to the fullback. It's always nice to get some fullback gloving in on there, Cody, because, I mean, the fullback does more work than you really see, and then he really gets credit for, too. So for him to get a handoff here and there in the game, it's always nice to see, you know. It's kind of rewarding if you're a fullback.
Time ticking away for Elizabeth Forward here. 2 minutes and 21 seconds left to go in the game. Here's the snap. It is another handoff that goes up the middle, breaking away to the 45-yard line, where he's stopped for another first down. That's Jalen French on the run.
Jalen French doing a good job executing the left side there of the line. Find an open hole and take off up it. Belle Vernon staying strong, though, making sure they don't break, but they are bending. Rushing yards are adding up now in the favor of Elizabeth Forward. That's going to help pad the stat sheet a little bit for Elizabeth Forward, make them look a little bit better in the rushing column at least.
Two receivers to the right, one to the left, two men back for Davidson, who is under center. Hands it off to his fullback. And the fullback gets about no gain on the play. The clock continues to run at 1:41 left to go.
Hermsman on the carry on that one again. He'll take as many carries as the coaches will give him. He enjoys running the ball. Any fullback really does. I'll tell you what, though, Cody, as a lineman, I never got to touch the ball much in football, you know. But it was always good whenever you did have a chance to touch it. And Hermsman is really feeling that right now.
Oh, yeah, definitely. The ball is where all the attention is. So that's a good social aspect for any player. Davidson keeping it for himself, rolling out to the outside. Melting some more time off the clock as he is sacked for about a 2-yard loss. It will be third down and a long 12 yards for Elizabeth Forward. We now have under 1 minute left to go in the game.
That's an advantage of rugby, actually, Cody, is being able to be a big man and also being able to touch the ball. I enjoy the sport of rugby, and the sport of rugby actually is what caused the start of football, American football. So these football players on this field can thank the creators of rugby, Webb Ellis, the creator of rugby. So, you know, just a little history for you guys listening at home in the late 30 seconds left in this game. Looks like they're going to have to conclude one more play before the end of this game. is official.
The play clock reads 9 seconds. Game clock reads 18. So there will have to be one more play. It looks like Davidson will just take a knee. The clock stops at 10.9 seconds. Belle Vernon taking not taking a timeout. The clock resumes. And that is the concluding play of the game, Tyler. We see Elizabeth Forward sneak away with a great win here tonight.
A great win for Elizabeth Forward tonight. Gives him a lot of momentum and a lot of pride to be able to go in to the remainder of your season with a big win over your rivals in Belle Vernon.
For myself, Cody Jeanette, and Tyler Harris, and all of our camera crew, graphic crew, and everybody else in between, thank you for watching this edition of CUTV's High School Game of the Week. This has been Elizabeth Forward versus Belle Vernon. Your final score, Elizabeth Forward 35, Belle Vernon 13.